July 28th, 2007, Sid Vicious debuts for Pro Wrestling Unplugged. And right now, it sounds like we got J.C. Ryder coming to the ring, if this music is any indication, Dan.
That's right. One half of the New Jersey All-Stars, J.C. Ryder, will be in action against the death-defying Zach McGuire.
He's definitely deaf, all right. He doesn't really defy death, does he? He defines it.
Jersey rules. I can't bash Jersey too much. I know a lot of good people. I know a lot of good friends.
Like Jay Flack, for one.
Yeah, unfortunately.
And right now, you see these fans are giving J.C. Ryder a little hard time. He's taking his shirt off his back for them.
And he's posing in front of the Whiteboard Mafia.
Whiteboard Mafia. They're not even real people.
Coming out to the great Bon Jovi tune.
Ladies and gentlemen, from New Jersey, weighing in tonight at 155 pounds, he is the New Jersey All-Star, J.C. Ryder!
And you know how Philadelphia is just a suburb of New Jersey anyway.
Well, wait a second.
No, I don't think so.
Jersey's only known for being the cousin of Philadelphia and New York City.
Yeah, well, Philadelphia's the retarded cousin of Jersey.
Please.
I mean, please, it's the definition of it. J.C. Ryder is a top-notch talent from New Jersey.
He's a real attitude, though. Since debuting here in PW, he's had a real attitude, and he's given that attitude to Rocky.
You know who else has got an attitude? Zach McGuire.
He doesn't have any attitude. He's one of the nicest guys in this business today. I enjoy him.
He's always smiling and making me speak up. I don't like him one bit.
He can't hear. He's deaf. He can't win either. Come on, he's not tall clatter. He's deaf. He can't hear you.
Yeah, where's the closed captioning for this guy? Does he need it for his intro?
Weighing in at 170 pounds, formerly from Tampa, now making his home in Cincinnati, Ohio, this is Zach McGuire!
From Tampa to Cincinnati,
one of the great young talents that PWU has discovered. And he's going to make a big name for himself right here in Pro Wrestling Unplugged. He, along with Zach Gallen, took out Johnny Cadger a few months back. That DVD is now available at the Pro Shop at ProWrestlingUnplugged.com.
And you know what? That's more than enough, the event you're talking about right there.
Right.
And he's going to need more than his in-ring abilities to beat J.C. Ryder tonight, because J.C. Ryder, just like Jersey, ain't going down any further. He's going to start his winning streak tonight.
Here we go, Derek Savato calling for the bell to start the action here.
Well, Zach McGuire doesn't know the bell sounded, I believe.
Listen to this crowd. They're not showing your home state any love there, Jake.
You know what? It's not like this is helping Zach McGuire, and he can't feed off their energy. He can't hear them. He can't see them. He can't do anything.
Oh, good arm drag takedown by J.C. Ryder.
That was Jersey-rific, in fact. You know, I gotta give McGuire his wrestling due, in fact. He is a 1996 Special Olympics wrestling gold medalist, and he did it with broken freaking hearing.
Oh, you're shameful, Jake. Shameful.
And he's getting out-wrestled right now by the able body.
You don't know your limits, do you?
You know, we don't allow handicaps in New Jersey, and that's a reason. And there's a reason for it. Taxes. You know what? That's why Jersey has some of the lowest taxes in the nation. It's because we don't allow handicaps. We kill them off at birth.
J.C. Ryder, I'm going to ignore your comments, has Zach McGuire an arm bar here. Now into an arm ringer. Zach McGuire rolling through, nipping up. And now he's got the arm ringer on J.C. Ryder.
You know what? This match shouldn't even be taking place.
And why is that?
Because when people are born with birth defects, such as hearing, they should be aborted.
You disgust me.
Oh, what the hell was that? J.C. Ryder's being outsmarted by the mentally challenged.
He's not mentally challenged.
What? Nice little kind of a springboard arm drag. And J.C. Ryder looks a little worse for there right now. While Zach McGuire is going for...
Zach McGuire off the second rope. Oh, big drop kicks in. J.C. Ryder down to the floor here at the new Alhambra Arena.
And Zach McGuire is a great high flyer because he has nothing to lose.
Whoa! Look at that move! Taking out J.C. Ryder. He is truly death-defying.
You know, that was a beautiful plancha right there, and there's no doubt about it. He's a talented wrestler, but what I'm saying is he should not be in the ring with J.C. Ryder.
Why?
Because he should have his own special division, like he has his own special parking spot. And you know what? Maybe even Zach McGuire could have heard that.
J.C. Ryder being thrown back into the ring by Zach McGuire here. J.C. Ryder on the...
Oh, he flicked it right in his eyes. The bottom, the middle rope,
oh,
right there.
Geez. That was something different. I've never seen that before.
That was great. Maybe he's blind now too.
J.C. Ryder.
Oh!
Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me?
Vicious sledgehammer off the apron by J.C. Ryder. Did you see that, Dan Cowie?
I saw it. Vicious is not that. Vicious is Sid, who will be taking on 2 Cold Scorpio later on tonight for the PW World Heavyweight Championship.
Wow, Vicious is also that wind chop.
What is he? J.C. Ryder, oh!
Almost like a stun gun or a hot shot right on the ring apron.
Sending Zach McGuire back into the ring.
Zach McGuire doesn't look with us right now.
He's kicked out after 2.
There's a little group that I think Zach McGuire should be part of. And I don't think it's with the able bodies in the ring. Perhaps he should join that gang, the Crips, where the people are naturally born with birth defects. Cripples.
Oh, Jake, you don't run out, do you? Look at that snapmare takedown. Using the ears. Oh, and a big old kick to the back.
Got him right in the spine there.
Cover here, 1, 2, and a kick out after 2.
You know, pick me Tommy a winner, Dan Talley. Both these guys need the victory.
They both need the victory. I don't know. I've seen Zach Fire. He's been impressive in his matches against Johnny, the new Batman, Cashmere.
Well, that's before Batman traded his angel wings for the Bat Wings.
That is true. Now, J.C. Ryder on the ring apron here. Springboard. Oh, build slash cover here. One, two, and a kick out after two. And this match lives on here at Iron and Steel, coming to you from the new Alhambra Arena in beautiful South Philadelphia.
You know, J.C. Ryder is smart right there. He let his aggression out a little bit too much when he started arguing with the ref, but he went right back into a hold right there, working on the neck of Zach McGuire.
Oh, man, Joel Jacker. Zach McGuire back up on his feet. Catches him. Oh, yeah, right to the knee. Boom! Taking down a cutter to the back of the neck.
And right now, Zach McGuire has bought himself a little bit of time. And J.C. Ryder will be down for a while. But since McGuire's taking the brunt of the beating in this match, I think Ryder's going to be getting up first.
Oh, no. Zach McGuire back to his feet, as is J.C. Ryder. Both me. Oh, Zach McGuire. Big forearm chop now to J.C. Ryder. Another forearm. And J.C. Ryder being sent off the ropes. Zach McGuire catching. Big slam. Taking down J.C. Ryder.
Oh, here.
Zach McGuire. Springboard for the second rope.
Quebrada.
One, two. Oh, a close call. But this match still lives on here at Iron and Steel.
Zach McGuire looks frustrated right there. If that springboard moonsault on the inside didn't put away J.C. Ryder, he's got to be thinking, what else from his arsenal does he have to bust out to beat Ryder?
Zach McGuire calling for something here. Charge in, up and over. Oh, he's on the ring apron. Oh, enziguri kick to the side of the head. J.C. Ryder instantly catches him. What is this? Oh, my goodness. What has he got planned here? Oh, that spike DDT. That can't be good. Zach McGuire has got to be done here. Cover. Oh, and a kick out after two.
That Walt Whitman Bridge DDT almost took out Zach McGuire.
Once again, no love from Philadelphia to this Jersey native.
What does Philadelphia love besides beating their wives?
Love lots of things. Good performance.
Wow, nice
run. Oh, and a kick out.
Not really sure what kind of roll-up that was. Looked like the Lucha style to me.
Oh, J.C. Ryder on the attack of Zach McGuire quickly.
Oh, yeah.
Zach McGuire reverses it. Arm right here. Wait a second. Whoa. Oh, look at that cover. Two, three. That's like a Russian leg sweep.
6 minutes, 40 seconds. Your winner, Zach McGuire.
He almost gave J.C. Ryder a false sense of security like he was going for an abdominal stretch, but instead he rolled him up and pinned him.
I've never seen
that. Is cheating.
That's not cheating. It was a fair cover. You're just disappointed. Their hometown native lost the match. Get over it.
Home state.
Whatever town, state.
You know what?
Is this a suburb of Philadelphia?
No. Philly's a suburb of New Jersey. You ever hear of weird New Jersey?
Weird New Jersey. Did you ever hear Independence Hall, the Liberty Bell, Citizens Bank Park?
Oh, they're not real.
The new Alhambra Arena?
All right, that's real.
Here we go. The debut of Gangrel, the two brothers, Billy Blade and Gangrel. Bloodline makes its return here to Pro Wrestling Unplugged. Listen to this crowd for a true, I guess I could say legend of this business.
Wrestling superstar.
Although I love the guy he's fighting more so, Pete Hunter. I'm a big fan of Pete Hunter, as you all know. But Gangrel, I've always been a fan of the dark side. A fan of the vampire warrior.
You see me like those goth chicks?
Too bad that Gangrel is going to get his ass kicked by Team Pit, Aramis, and Pete Hunter.
You know what? That remains to be seen. But right now, they're going through a little bit of ritual, a sacrifice almost, for Pete Hunter and Aramis' souls.
These lost boys, these vampires, the original
Ladies
vampires.
At a combined weight of 500 pounds from Santa Cruz, California, the team of Billy Blade and Grand Gale. Ladies and
meant to say Gangrel.
He's been known to blow spots on the mic.
He's nervous. He's nervous that this vampire warrior, these two vampire warriors, are in the ring. These lost boys.
He's afraid they're going to... He's probably played too much Castlevania.
Here we go. My boy, the complete Piotr, Aramis,
Christ.
And the original, the real Pitbull, Gary Wolf. Not those pipsqueaks that you see on Friday night.
You know what? Has got to challenge themselves in the ring. But Pete Hunter proved last month, and I'm going to give it up to him, when he pinned Joey Mercury, that there is no one, not a thing, that he cannot handle in that ring.
We're not allowed to say Mercury, Jake.
Whatever, it's just...
There he is! This is my team. I love these guys. Pitbull, Aramis, and Pete Hunter. Come on, how can you not love these guys?
And Gary Wolf...
The future of this business is right here in front of you, Jake.
And Gary Wolf is ready to unleash Pete Hunter and Aramis, Michael Vick style, on Bloodline.
Jake. And it's a good analogy, though. I'll tell you what, Jake. Look at the Pitbull. He's not intimidated by these vampires at all. Pete Hunter's not intimidated. Aramis isn't intimidated. Look at him. Look at him.
Shades of Anthony Durantes and Gary Wolf right there with that pose.
Ladies and gentlemen, they are led to the ring by a former ECW Tag Team Champion and Television Champion. This is the original Pitbull, Gary Wolf.
Not that pipsqueak you see on some TV show.
At a combined weight of 447 pounds, first from Philadelphia, this is Aramis! And his partner from the main line, the complete Pete Hunter!
Yes!
Going T-P-I-T!
Or Pitt.
Physically intense training right there. But how tough was their training to deal with these vampires?
Vampires are no match for pit bulls.
You know what? The only people who can handle vampires are virgins. So you know what? Pete Hunter should be fine.
I've been to the bars with him on a Friday night. He gets plenty of ladies.
You know what, though? After Pete Hunter's name was announced, the next time we hear Pete Hunter's name announced, it's going to sound a little something like this. Congress calls Pete Hunter to the stand.
No asterisks needed, Jake. No asterisks needed.
They tie up. He's overpowered at Billy Blade right now, but I don't think the intimidation factor for Blade exists that it does when Pete wants to hook up with Gangrel.
Well, here we go. Pete is calling in the Vampire Warrior. He is calling in Gangrel into this matchup.
You know, Gangrel's track record speaks for itself. He's competed in every major company. But Pete Hunter, I think he's intimidated, but once he actually gets into it, see, he got outsmarted right there, though.
Gangrel is a legend in this business. He's been around the block a time or two. But Pete Hunter, look at him. Look at the shape he's in compared to Gangrel. He's younger. He's more vicious, Pete Hunter is. Pete Hunter's got that eye of the tiger, thanks to the original Pitbull, Gary Wolf. Oh, look at that! Oh. Gangrel up into the air. And here we go. Slams him down. Gangrel is no match for the complete Pete Hunter.
Yeah, but notice
Pitt.
What Gangrel did. His experience was obvious. He suckered Pete Hunter in twice now. Twice he's suckered in Pete Hunter.
Okay, I'll give that to you. Pete Hunter is still a little inexperienced, but time will tell with these two young superstars. The future of this business. Two people the Pitbull's taken under his wing.
You know what? They live the gothic. Well, he reversed them right there, but nice display of power by Pete Hunter. I gotta give him that.
Big slam. And here he is tagging in Aramis, one of the high flyer of the two. And Aramis is already calling for it. Up to the top of springboard, moonsault. Ooh, a kick out after one.
Yeah, you know what, they haven't worn him bad enough. The split legged would not pin him right there.
Aramis sending Blade after one. Big kick to the face, sending Blade down. Aramis going for the cover here. One, two. And Gangrel almost having to break up that count, but Billy Blade able to kick out after two.
You know what, though? That just shows the experience of Gangrel. He was on the ball. A lesser experienced wrestler would not have already been a quarter of the way in the ring at one and a half.
Aramis going up top once again. Wait a second. Gangrel. Is it? Oh! Ripping him off that top rope with authority. Oh, what a spin kick from Billy Blaine. Taking down Aramis.
He got great height on that shades of Owen Hart with that kick.
Blade's tagging in his brother. That's right, these two are brothers. Gangrel and Billy Blade.
Perhaps blood brothers. We don't really know. We don't know the lineage of the Gangrel Billy Blade family.
No, they are definitely brothers. Followers of vampirism. The Lost Boys.
Oh! Nice corkscrew elbow. He got Aramis in the gut rather than the chest.
Aramis cover here. Kick out after two.
You know, Aramis, he's been on a losing streak. You can't deny that. You always try to. But Aramis has not even had a pinfall victory since January. 6 months in the hole for Aramis.
Well, it's about to change here tonight, I can tell you that right now. Team Pitt is going to come out victorious. I can feel it in my blood.
Speaking of blood, they have not gotten the same advantage, a steady advantage, on Bloodline at one point in this match.
Well, they haven't had a steady advantage. You're right about that. Now, look at this double team. Come on, Keenan, break it up here.
They have till five.
Oh, hey,
Aramis, John!
Look at that! That's not a cheap shot at all. That's called Team Pitt training at its best.
Oh, well, that's cool.
Gangrel being met with a fist, spinning DDD.
And right now it's a race to see who can get to their corner first. Aramis is actually a little bit closer, but he's rolling in the wrong direction.
And look at my boy, Pete Hunter. He really wants in this match. Tagged in. The complete Pete Hunter taking out Gangrel. And now taking out Billy Blade. Look at this. The Pitbull has trained these two very well.
Oh,
but the thumb to the eyes. Now that's a cheap shot, Jake. Wait a minute, reversal. Spine buster with authority from the complete Pete Hunter.
You know what? I will say this. Pete Hunter, when he's put in a pressure situation, always excels.
He does excel. Last month, he took on and defeated Joey Matthews at Crazy 8, which is now available on DVD at ProWrestlingUnplugged.com. Gangrel being sent off the ropes by Team Pitt. Oh, he said Gangrel throws Pete Hunter out, is now on the attacker. Wait a second. This is that trademark. Impact! Oh, my God, this can't be. No, Pete Hunter's in. Roll Bridge, Gangrel over the top. And here we go. Billy Blade misses with his trademark spin kick. And Pete Hunter. It's over, Jake.
No.
It is over.
You can get out still.
Completion. Cover here. One, two, three.
Time of the match, 5 minutes, 15 seconds. Your winners, Team PIT, Aramis, and the complete Pete Hunter.
That's right. Team Pit. Lost by the Pitbull Guy Wolf himself and pretty much the new Pitbulls.
And you know what? That was impressive right there. You gotta give Team Pitt a ton of credit. They scored the win, they were victorious, but what lies ahead for Team Pitt at this point?
Team Pitt, they might have iced themselves into the tag team title race.
It takes more than one victory.
I don't know, Jake. They have a good shot here. They win tonight. Proven buddies, the best around later on tonight. They gotta be two other number one contender possibilities after the SATs and All Might Legal finally finish up their long-running feud inside a steel cage here tonight. Here we go. Our next matchup. A man who just lost his World Heavyweight Championship last month at Crazy 8, Devin Moore. He's got to get back in those winning ways as he takes on this man. He's making his way down to the ring at this time. The so-called King of the Rats, Z-Bar, the Superstar.
You know what? He is the King of the Rats. And you know what? The rattiest thing he's had his face in lately was Jerry Sags' armpit. Second rattiest thing, I guess.
Yeah, I would say second rattiest. I've seen who Z-Bar has left this building with.
I've seen what he's done in this building.
I don't want to know, Jake. I don't want to know.
Yeah, well.
This guy is rather slimy, skeevy.
But But you know what? He's a hell of a talent. No matter
what. Ladies and gentlemen, he's from anywhere he damn well pleases. Weighing it tonight at 216 pounds. He claims he is worth the price of admission for whatever you paid for your tickets tonight. This is Z-Bo!
A cocky son of a gun.
You've never met his father. Maybe he's a very nice man.
Yeah, usually guys like this come from very nice people.
You know what, though? Z-Bo is a hell of a talent, and he's just progressed so much in the last 6 to 8 months that a lot of people kind of discount his abilities.
Well, Z-Bo got a little too excited. He plays and he faces Devin Moore for the World Heavyweight Championship here tonight.
And you know what? Maybe if Devin Moore didn't blow it, he would be facing Devin Moore for the World Heavyweight title. A great champion, but a champion who can't be holding his title.
Look at Devin Moore. He looks like homeless. For the last, 10 months, he was champion? 10 months as champion? And now, look at that. And even before that, he held the now defunct Junior Heavyweight Championship. Devin Moore is like the first time I've seen him without a heavyweight championship or any kind of gold around his waist.
You know what? Maybe it's what he needs. I feel that he lost that match, not due to effort, but due to just the wear and tear of being champion for the last 10 months. And let's not forget about months and months of prior junior heavyweight title defenses that just racked up on him and took their toll on Devin Moore.
Ladies and gentlemen, from Philadelphia, weighing it tonight at 175 pounds, he is the former PWU heavyweight champion. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Devin.
And you know what?
He's still getting a champion reception here, Jake.
You know what? A champion isn't measured by the title on the waist. A champion is measured by their heart. And even without the title, as much as I dislike him, Devin Moore is one hell of a wrestler.
Yeah, Devin Moore definitely will be back in that title race sooner than we can all imagine.
And you know what? He needs this. I think he needs time away from the title to appreciate what he had. He was one of the youngest men to ever hold any kind of world title, and the pressure mounting on that had to get to him, and maybe right now he can almost rebuild himself and get himself back on track, and this is a good starting point, a match against Z-Bar.
But you know what's amazing here is, for the last almost 3 years of PW's existence, Devin Moore has always been seen as the underdog in this company. Now, in this matchup, even though Z-Bar has more years under his belt, Devin Moore is definitely seen as the top dog in this matchup.
I'll have to agree. You know what? Devin Moore, one loss since. I don't even know the last time he was actually pinned. And you know what? He hasn't been pinned in the longest time because he wasn't pinned at Crazy 8. Devin Moore's shoulders have not been put on that mat in well over, I'm going to say, 16, 17, 18 months.
He never lost a junior heavyweight championship. He threw it away.
Exactly. Ever since his return to PWU 2 years ago, Devin Moore has definitely been the standout wrestler. He is the face of this company. No matter what is coming, Sid Vicious, Too Cold Scorpio, Raven, Sandman, any of those people, Devin Moore is the definition of pro wrestling up close.
Z-Bar now the snapmare takedown. But Devin Moore. Well, you can tell the difference between the two. Z-Bar is cocky, whereas Devin Moore is more laid back. He knows that he could be cocky, really. He really could. Hands away from it. He's a former heavyweight champion.
And you know what? Devin Moore has the right to be cocky. Z-Bar has the right to be cocky. Z-Bar has a good chance of winning this matchup. You know why? Because Devin Moore's head is probably not in the game. Like I was saying, he needs the pressure taken off of him heading into this match of not having the title. But you know what? Z-Bar can capitalize on that.
Z-Bar with a side headlock here on Devin Moore.
What is that loss going to be for Devin Moore that Z-Bar can capitalize on? That's what Z-Bar is thinking.
Z-Bar taking down Devin Moore. Off the ropes, Devin Moore leapfrogs over. Oh, look at that. Hip toss taking down Z-Bar. Arm drag. Z-Bar is not looking good against a former champion as being taken out by a more than a regular dropkick.
More than a regular wrestler is Devin Moore. And what? Oh, he's stalking him. This can't be legal.
Devin Moore. Oh, he's a fool, Z-Bar. Z-Bar doesn't know it. Suicide dive into the front row here at the new Alhambra Arena.
That was like a tomfoolery
suicide dive. Look at all this fluid flying.
Seymour just stole somebody's beer and threw it all over the crowd.
There was more fluids flying there than Z-Bar's bedroom. King of the Rats. Two count only by Devenport. He almost had Z-Bar put away right there, and it was back on the winning track.
Devenport here on the attack of Z-Bar. Like I said, Z-Bar, the big forearm. Oh, another one, almost stunning Devenport.
And you gotta look at Devenport's face expressions every time Z-Bar hits him. He's pounding him right in the face, and Devenport's almost freezing up. Oh!
Man, stiff kick from Z-Bar.
That Savak kick took down Devenport, and that elbow didn't help anything.
It did not, and Z-Bar is looking good. If Z-Bar wins this match, you have to imagine this could put him in the heavyweight title race here in Pro Wrestling Unplugged.
And you know Z-Bar's looking to get Scorpio back in the ring.
That's right. He was the guy who took on Scorpio in Scorpio's first match back here back in May at Pride, Pain, and Punishment, available on DVD at ProWrestlingUnplugged.com as well as ProWrestlingPress.com.
Neckbreaker by Devenport.
Devenport with the cover here. One, two, and kick out after two.
Devenport right now, he's not trying to throw out his heavy artillery against Z-Bar. He's trying to keep things simple. He's looking for quick pins.
Oh, wait a second. Z-Bar reverses it. Oh, misses with the double axe handle. And Devenport with it. Oh, look at that.
Flying. I don't know.
Well, here it is. This is more than just an elbow gun. Oh, maybe no.
He is the first person I can think of to actually block that move.
Z-Bar's been watching his tapes. Available at ProWrestlingUnplugged.com.
Yeah. First the flying ass flyers get Z-Bar in the corner, but that time he caught Devenport when he was going for the velocity elbow.
Cover here. Two. And Devenport is able to kick out after two. Devenport proving why he was champion for the last 10 months. World champion for the last 10 months.
You know, Z-Bar is taking it smart. He realizes Devenport has a speed advantage. You cut off Devenport's wind, he's not going to get the same quickness out of any of the steps he takes during this match. Thus, his offense, due to his light weight, is going to lose a lot of steam right there. He's not going to be able to hit you as hard.
Devenport, oh, ducks the clothesline. Wait a second, Z-Bar now with the waist lock. Devenport fighting out of it. Waist lock of his own. Oh, Z-Bar fights out another waist lock.
What's up?
Oh, Devenport puts that way in. Oh!
Inverse
DDT by Z-Bar. Cover here, two. Ooh, that was very close.
I'm surprised he didn't get him right there, because that caught Devenport way off guard with that inverted DDT. Moore almost folded up on it. Z-Bar surprised, too.
Z-Bar stalking his prey, stalking Devenport. Devenport does not look good here. Oh, big stomp to that shoulder.
Looks like he's gone for a Garvin stomp.
A stomp on his stomach. The other shoulder. He's been working the whole upper body of Devenport. Now working on the lower body. Look at it. He's taking almost like every part of the body of Devenport.
And that's what this does. It does. It's almost like a full body beatdown. Every part of your body feels pain on this move.
Oh, right into the face.
Especially your face.
Now you see, Z-Bar could capitalize on that and maybe cover, but he's too damn.
He did capitalize and go for a cover.
Yeah, after doing his own, whatever he called it.
Well, you gotta piss off the people. They piss you off, you gotta piss back. It's a pissing contest in this arena.
Sidewalk slam. Z-Bar now, is he going up top? Z-Bar is, this is looking at it.
Z-Bar has a hell of a moonsault. I've seen him do it a couple times now.
Z-Bar up top.
See him do it a couple times too and had the move well scouted.
That could have knocked out the rib cage of Z-Bar.
Well, the wind's out of him.
Drop kick into the corner goes Z-Bar. Oh, here we go. More than just an elbow.
And right now, Devenport, springboard, oh, cross body.
Over here, two. Oh, kick out after two. How the hell did Z-Bar just kick out of that?
I'll tell you how. Talking about Devenport having earlier, Z-Bar has the same amount.
I guess so. Z-Bar wants a fat heart.
Found it. He's like the Grinch. It's been growing as he's been getting better.
Devenport looks like he's trying to slam, but Z-Bar seems a little too heavy for Devenport. Oh, look at that uppercut to the back of the head. Devin Moore. Oh, look at that suplex.
Sato side suplex right there.
Off the ropes. Boom. Clothesline leg sweep. Cover here. Two.
Oh.
A kick out after two.
And you know what? That's how he defeated Joel Maximo at St. Patrick's Day Massacre to retain the heavyweight title. He's using the same moves that brought him to the dance against C-Bar here tonight, even though the title is not on the line.
Doesn't matter if the title's not on the line. Devin Moore is in the title race. He's going to impress Mr. Todd Gordon and possibly the PW Commissioner Idol should they be having any kind of play. If Devin
Whoa!
Oh, my God! Look at Devin Moore.
C-Bar thought he was in a safety zone, but he wasn't at all.
Nowhere is safe when Devin Moore is in this arena.
This guy
flies high, he flies low, he runs around, he can wrestle, he can high fly, he can be hardcore, he can do it all. He's more than just a dream.
You know, quit talking about how high he gets. We can all figure that out. And right now they're slugging it out on the outside, and I don't know who's got a better fighting background than these two, but Z-Bar, no, reversal, another reversal.
Oh, went to the front row.
Oh,
Devin Moore.
But Devin Moore catches him with a boot right to the face.
Oh, it's a
Bossman slam on the outside.
Devin Moore is down, and it is not good.
You know what? I think Z-Bar just broke the count. But he's going back out to go after Devin Moore even more. Or he's not sure where he is. Now he's got to figure it out.
Z-Bar, see, Z-Bar's going to... What's weird about Z-Bar is, as cocky as he is, it's almost like he could have won that match by count. He's so cocky that he has to pin Devin Moore, and that could be his biggest fall here in this match.
You know what? We've seen his cockiness cost him matches before, but if it wasn't for that cockiness, you got to wonder how long would he stay in some of these matches.
Cover here. One, two, and a kick out. See? He threw up the count and gotten a victory over a former heavyweight champion.
You know what, though? It looks so much better on your record. A count-out victory doesn't mean much unless it's... But a pinfall victory over the man who was never pinned for his title, Z-Bar can lay claim to being the uncrowned champion if that was the case. If he could pin Devin Moore.
Z-Bar now lifting up Devin Moore, positioning him.
Giving him the high limit, lifting him up.
There we go.
What's he going for here? Oh.
Devin Moore fights out.
Oh!
Enziguri kick. Devin Moore taking out Z-Bar. Both men are down. Who is going to get to their feet first? Who is going to be victorious here? And Iron and Steel.
Well, Devin Moore looks like he's coming back to life. It's like Dr. Frankenstein pulls the switch because he's getting a little burst of energy.
It's from these fans who love Devin Moore, love the former champion, a man who is homeless without his belt.
You know what? He looks a little naked, but you know what? It could just be time for that title back on his waist.
Both men are up on their feet. Oh! Meeting with fists.
Oh!
Z-Bar, old cock. Devin Moore answers right back. Z-Bar answers right back.
You know what? But this is just firing them up. As painful as this would be on me or you, this is just firing them up. Look at Devin Moore's face.
Oh, look at that shot. Oh, a chop from Z-Bar.
That was a thud-like chop.
Z-Bar dancing with a chop. Oh, another chop.
Oh, man. Dude, I don't even know if it's how to call this.
Forearm to Fury from Devin Moore. Chop to the side of the head. Spinning forearm.
What has he got here? He'll finish. What?
Oh,
sunset.
No.
Out of water.
Oh, he's roll like anything with this.
No way!
No, that did not just happen.
Time of the match, 12 minutes, 17 seconds. Your winner.
Look at some
C-Bar.
Look at some of the faces of the fan of these crowd. They are almost in shock as much as me and you are. Z-Bar, his first win in several months, and it's against Devin Moore.
Devin Moore, the man who was not pinned for his championship, just got pinned by Z-Bar.
And you know what? 100% clean.
out of it. However, Trent has a big task ahead of him as he's taking on Joey Matthews.
And you know what? Joey Matthews lost his first match here at PWU, but I don't think that's any kind of meter to rank him on, as Joey Matthews has proven his skills in wrestling for the last, I don't know, 12, 13 years. Joey Matthews is definitely a top guy for Trent Atkin to be facing, and one of these two will be taking on the winner of Sid Scorpio and whoever Sid or Scorpio defends the title against in August and in September at the third anniversary show.
Third anniversary of our subsite up and ready at ProWrestlingUnplugged.com.
You know, Trent has to change it all. He's got to get his money from his rats. I wonder if they're going to put that baby in his tights. No. No such luck.
If they did that, we'd have to get child services down here.
Yeah, I know. That'd be like my guest appearance on The Catch a Predator. But enough about that. Trent Acid has got a chance to beat a match to regain the PW Heavyweight title, a title he lost 13 months ago to Too Cold Scorpio.
Trent Acid now running around the ring, taking his good old time to get back into the ring.
Ladies and gentlemen, he is led to the ring by Discount Dewey Donovan. And they're in the ring at 9.5 inches.
He looks a lot taller.
From South Philadelphia, Japan, introducing the international superstar. This is Trent Acid.
Look at this sinister face on his manager, Joey Donovan.
You gotta do the do.
Trent needs to get more money from out the crowd.
Well, you know, he wasn't booked last month. He's gotta make up for it. Now he's just getting a little action, even if he is 50.
Only 50?
Well.
I'm surprised you think so generous, Shake.
I'm not very generous to women usually. Long story. But Trent Acid, generous amount of ability, and he's gonna need it all tonight against Joey Matthews.
More money Trent Acid's got. He's got the out of his shorts.
Looks like he's running a pawn shop down there.
He lost the vibe with a complete piano last month. He's looking to get on his winning ways here and get a shot at the championship at the third anniversary, September 15th, 2007, here at the New Orleans Arena. Here is a man who's traveled the world over, won almost every recognizable title he can win. Here is Joey Matthews.
And speaking of third anniversary, here's a man who's no stranger to red carpet arrivals, Joey Matthews, as he is ready to take aim and win his first title in PWU, but he's on track for tonight. What a hell of a road. Pete is going to have his ass for that.
Oh, look at this guy. A superstar. He's a superstar, Jake.
You know what? You know nothing about being a superstar, so where are you to get off at mocking him?
Jake, I am a god of all media, please.
Well, I'm the Tom Cruise of announcing. Yeah. You got no rebuttal for that. As these two go face to face in the ring, friends collide, contenders match, and there's already trash talking from the shot at the gold on the line.
Weighing tonight at 211 pounds from Los Angeles, California.
Jeff could not impress at his former friend's accomplishments.
As you all know, I'm a very important person. I got something very important to say, and I require complete silence immediately.
I will contribute to the Lindsay Lohan fund. He's got to be friends with her. He knows all the Hollywood A-listers. He helped free Paris.
Contrary to popular belief, I did not get fired. I am on a self-imposed summer vacation from the WWE.
That's amazing.
Self-imposed summer vacation.
I landed in Philadelphia International Airport this morning. I took the short drive up 95, and I was thinking, there's a friend of mine, an old friend, by the name of Trent Acid. I haven't seen him in 4 years, and I was going to see him tonight. Much to my chagrin, I show up at this building. I see Trent Acid, one of the first people I saw. I stick my hand out for him to shake it. I said, Trent, how are you? Good to see you, pal. Trent Acid looked at my hand, put his hands in his pockets, and he walked away from me.
Why that, mother? But Trent Acid has not forgotten his roots here in Philadelphia, like Joey Matt.
At first, I was offended, and rightfully so. What a sign of disrespect for one of the greatest sports entertainers in the world today.
I concur.
You see, Trent, jealousy will only get you so far. You see, Trent Acid and myself wrestled in this building about 4 years ago. I come back to see him today, and he's jealous. He's jealous because he doesn't look as good as I look. He's jealous because he didn't make it as far as I did. He's jealous because he didn't make hundreds of thousands of dollars like Joey Matthews did. He's jealous because he wasn't on national TV. He's jealous because, just like all of you morons, he should be down on his hands and knees kissing my beautiful white butt for coming back to Philadelphia.
Yeah, he's got a hot ass. Trent Acid should be kissing it.
Trent Acid, even though I'm ridiculously good looking, even though you're a professional wrestler and I'm a sports entertainer, even though I have all the ability in the world, I am not a good person. I do not do nice things. And when this man rings that bell, I am gonna beat some respect into you. Ring the bell.
He needs it.
Matthews deserves no respect for the way he came in here and acted last month and again this month.
You know, a lot of things this Joker said is true. I haven't seen you in 4 years, and the reason why I didn't shake your hand is because all that money you made and all the dreams that you followed just turned you into an asshole.
What?
He did. Matthews blew me off at a tailgate party last month at Crazy 8.
Well, that's you.
Talking about respect, I deserve some respect too. These fans deserve respect.
Hey, these fans are asking for Joey Matthews to present himself to them.
You know something? Yeah, I am bitter. Because frankly, you're just a backseat wannabe ripoff. You wanted to call yourself a chick magnet? Well, guess what? I got a bunch of girls in the front row giving me money every time I come to the ring.
Yeah, well, looks like you accused them, kicked them all in the face anyway. Don't be proud
now,
of that.
Now, enough of this talk, and you came here and disrespected the people. That's fine. I might have not seen eye to eye with these people along the years. But one thing I have in common with them is that I'm from Philadelphia.
Which means you're trash.
Absolutely not.
When you disrespect them, you disrespect me, and I'm going to kick your ass.
What a foul mouth that Trent Acid has.
Locked up in his center ring. Look at him. Like two bulls fighting on their opponent in rage with fury. These former friends are glad here to be a number one contender for the PWE World Heavyweight title at the third anniversary this September.
You know, pick me a winner. Who do you think's going to win? Trent Acid or Joey Matthews?
Oh, well, I've had my runs with the backseat boys as of late. They seem to turn over a new leaf, realizing that...
Well, they've burnt a lot of leaves in the process to do that.
But I think Trent Acid has the ability to come in on top and once again become the PWE World Heavyweight title.
You know what? He has ability, but does he have the ability to beat Joey Matthews tonight?
And drop kick, taking down Joey Matthews. Both men up and over the top rope and into the front row of the crowd here at the new Alhambra Arena.
And right now, Trent Acid is at the advantage, trying to get the crowd behind him. They're already behind him. I don't think he has to try for that because they're all jealous of Joey Matthews.
Trent Acid back into the ring here. Joey Matthews is not looking very pretty, so to speak, on the outside. And then Trent Acid, he lands on his feet like a cat. So it's a new Trent Acid. Just Trent Acid looks reborn after taking last month off.
Yeah, he actually hasn't had a match as he defeat the Messiah at More Than Enough. And right now he's in firm control of this match on Joey Matthews.
Trent Acid taking Joey Matthews, beating a pretty boy using these guardrails here. Taking a pillar to post, guardrail to guardrail.
And what?
Right. Oh.
Trent Acid is not.
Trent Acid, my goodness. Springboard off the second row. Taking out Joey Matthews. And almost taking out the front row here. Listen to this crowd getting behind Trent Acid and his crazy maneuvers here for Pro Wrestling Unplugged at Iron and Steel. This truly is a Trent Acid reborn here tonight.
That's right. He just did an acai moonsault on Joey Matthews. I don't know the last time I saw Trent Acid perform that move.
With such precision, at least. Such precision.
And right now he's mauling.
Come here.
A lot of wrestlers would have tried to just take down their opponent real cleanly, but Acid didn't care. He mauled Matthews because he wanted that cover.
It's almost like this Johnny, the new Batman, has become the new Batman. Trent Acid. It's almost inspired Trent Acid here.
Well, Johnny Cashmere inspires many people.
Trent Acid sending Matthews off the ropes. Oh, Matthews catches himself. Trent Acid up and over. Tried to land on the ring, but cannot.
Yeah, but he had a beautiful recovery, landing on his feet on the floor.
Trent Acid now going upstairs. Look at Matthews here using Mike Keener.
Hit Keener.
Senior referee is wild. Wait a second. Matthews sending Trent Acid off the top rope and into the guardrail here.
Joey Matthews is a thinking man's wrestler. He learned a lot.
Oh, he's not a wrestler. He admitted himself. He's a sports entertainer.
Well, sports entertainers are bad. Pro wrestling isn't real. Sports entertainment is real. That's where the heart and soul of this business is.
I love that tie in the front row. Vic fears PETA. But I don't think Joey Matthews fears PETA with that jacket.
I know. I'm surprised it hasn't been covered in paint yet. Oh,
hard shot sending out Trent Acid.
You know, you almost wonder if these two had not seen each other until this match began, if we would be seeing a totally different match. They got under each other's skin just hours before this contest, and now they're taking it out on each other. We would probably be seeing a lot more clean-cut wrestling style.
Joey Matthews sending that chair, distracting Keenan, using another chair on Trent Acid. That dirty, rotten scoundrel.
That genius is more like it. There's a fine line in between genius and being an a-hole. And Joey Matthews is definitely...
He's over the line. He's an a-hole.
No.
He's disrespected everybody in the back last month. Disrespected me personally. And now disrespected Trent Acid here tonight.
So what? He disrespected you. And now you're trying to say that makes him a bad person?
He disrespected everybody in this building. He's forgotten his roots since me going up to Stamford, Connecticut.
Who would want to remember these roots? Beautiful. Delayed. Suplex. Joey Matthews. British Bulldog style right there, just as effective.
Over here. Oh, kick out after two. Trent Acid kicks out, proving why he's been a champion around the world himself. He might not have made it big time yet, but he's been in Japan. He's been in Europe. In the King of Europe Cup. PW World Heavyweight Champion, as well as other titles.
Well, I'm pretty sure PW in Japan are pretty big time, and Joey Matthews is just on summer vacation, dude.
Joey Matthews self-imposed summer vacation. He doesn't want to admit that he got fired.
Yeah, well, he's taking Trent Acid to summer school right now, and he's beating a C-minus into him.
Trent Acid. It's a new, look at him. Firing back up here. It's a new Trent Acid. A determined Trent Acid. A Trent Acid wanting to put himself at PWR. on the mat. Oh, that double knee to the gut of Joey Matthews. Oh, big kick to the face. Matthews,
oh, nice. Joey Matthews is just tricked. Trent Acid.
Look at this Boston Crab from the top turnbuckle. And he's using that turnbuckle almost as an extra leverage.
Yeah, it's like putting your knee in someone's back. He's really knocking the wind out of him in the process. Stretching the back, the legs, and even the upper respiratory system.
Joey Matthews, I hope he gets his just due here tonight.
What did he do wrong? What just due are you talking about?
I just hate cocky people. I just hate it.
You know why? Because you don't have enough confidence to act cocky. You can't hear. Are you trying to tell me Trent Acid isn't cocky?
Yeah, he's a bit cocky, but to an extent, he knows where his limits are. And a two count here, Trent Acid continuing on in this matchup here at Iron and Steel, an event which later on tonight, Sid Vicious makes his debut to take on Two Gold Scorpio for the World Heavyweight title. And pretty much the winner of that match could be facing one of these two men at the third anniversary, September the 15th, right here at the New Aham Arena.
And you know what? Both of these men are going to be watching that match very closely because they have got to prepare for whoever they will be facing at the anniversary show. I mean, granted, the title could change hands, but PW returns here on August 18th because the world champion has no way to prepare at that event. But tonight,
oh, look out, driving that and rubbing in his boot into the gut of Trent Acid.
Yeah, Trent Acid, he's had a long layoff. He had a hell of a match with Detox at Pro Wrestling Crest Fan Jam 2. And this match is exactly the type of, that was the exact match he needed to prepare for Joey Matthews here tonight.
Oh, look at that. A backbreaker. Really applying the pressure on Trent Acid's back. Oh, a couple knees. More than a couple. Good way to break out of that hole.
It's an excellent way to break out of that hole. Trent Acid is definitely, he's not going down easy. I think Joey Matthews is superior, but Trent Acid is not going down easy.
Big slam, Trent Acid down, Joey Matthews. Looks like he's going up top. Yes, he is. He's going to the second round quality.
Look at the scowl on Joey Matthews. That just breeds winner.
Look at that. Oh, misses with the big elbow.
And right now, Trent Acid has got to take advantage of this.
Oh, look at that. Kicks.
Roaring elbow.
Something you see on a street fight or something.
Well, that's where Trent Acid learned to fight on the streets. I think. Look at him. Oh,
look at that.
Pendulum kick.
Oh, double springboard.
Acid trip right there. I don't know what else you would call that. By being in control of this match, most of the match, Joey Mercury is not being beat down quite as much as Trent Acid, so Trent Acid's moves aren't having the same impact on Joey Mercury that they normally would. Look at him, Trent Acid has performed two great moves, and he can barely even get up right now.
Let Joel Jacker taking out Trent Acid. Looks like Joey Mercury's calling it. Ducks the clothesline. Two after that big driving power bomb.
Blue Thunder Driver only got a two count on Joey Matthews right there, and Trent Acid has got to wonder what he's got to bust out next, and it looks like he is signaling for the Yakuza kick.
Trent, he's sizing up Joey Matthews. Oh, Matthews blocks it, rolls him up. He's got the dice. He's got, oh, a kick down after two. I thought,
oh. I was hoping it was over.
Acid slamming down Matthews.
He's wasting too much time.
Misses with, wait, lands on his feet though. Ducks the clothesline. Big super kick.
Man,
I think he knocked out a two. Cover here, one, two. Oh, kick out after two.
And you know what? When Trent Acid hits a Savat kick like that, because of those workers' boots he's got on, he really lays into it. Those are a lot more painful than wrestling boots.
Steel tips. Steel tips, Timberlands. Trent Acid.
Trent Acid going up there slowly.
Oh, Matthews with a burst of energy, meeting Trent Acid in the corner. Both men are on the second rope.
Trent Acid jockeying for position, Dan.
Shoving off Matthews. Trent Acid going upstairs. Here at the new Alhambra Arena. Is it Matthews back up? Oh! Taking out Trent Acid. Taking out the money maker. The family jewels of Trent Acid.
Yeah, he just busted the safe in that bank.
Sperm bank.
But right now, Joey Matthews.
I got it, Jake. Don't worry.
Joey Matthews is in firm control right now. And Joey Matthews, last month, he superplexed Pete Hunter. Oh, and he's mocking Trent Acid. Beautiful.
Wait, that Trent Acid goes through.
No.
Oh, kick out after two. Matthews looks really frustrated, pissed off now. Trent Acid rolling him up again.
Wait a second.
Oh, Matthews lost grip a little bit there. But right now,
he's pushed on the ropes.
Oh, but what is Keener doing?
He's a veteran referee, Michael Keener is. He saw the fall on the ropes. Joey Matthews did not win this matchup.
He should have. What did he do wrong?
I don't care what they do up in Stamford, Connecticut. We don't approve of cheating here.
What did he do wrong? What did he do wrong?
Beat on the bottom ropes. You can't do that.
Oh, that's illegal now?
It's been illegal forever, Jake. Steel tip boots to the face of Joey Matthews. Wait, they
what? What the hell is wrong with Trent Acid? Been off beat shenanigans is he pulling?
Man, you can't have a hard try, but it is illegal here in PW.
You know, he doesn't have to try everything he sees others do.
That is true. That is true.
Trent Acid on the waist lock here. Oh, low blow! Low blow! Keener didn't see it.
Beautiful move by Joey Murphy. Oh!
Double arm. DDT. Picture perfect DDT.
Ladies and gentlemen, 12 minutes, 56 seconds, your winner of the match, Joey Matthews!
I cannot believe it. This man, who walked the red carpet September the 15th, on his way to a title shot against either True Cold Scorpio, Sid Vicious, or whoever we can pick that title next month on August the 18th. Joey Matthews, third anniversary show. He's got himself a world championship shot.
The future of PWU right there. The next PW champion, Vicious. He is a former WWF, WCW, World Heavyweight Champion. And tonight, he becomes the largest man to ever, ever challenge for the PWU Heavyweight Championship. He's headlined WrestleMania. He's headlined Starrcade. There is nothing that Sid Vicious has not done in professional wrestling. The man who rules the world, Sid. And he's looking very intimidating right now. Scorpio is in for probably his toughest challenge in all the title defenses he's made in his career. As you hear the chant of Psycho Sid go out through the crowd, let's look at the history between Sid and Two Cold Scorpio. They were in a car accident together in 1997. Scorpio brought it up in his promo, five clips in the car. And let's not forget, there was an incident between Arn Anderson and Sid Vicious in England in 1993, a near fatal incident that Scorpio risked his life to break up. These two might be friends, but as we saw in the previous match, when there is championship gold at stake, there are no friends.
Jake, Sid is a scary individual.
He's a giant man.
I'm gonna break a little, you know, tape baby and say, I do the DVD covers here at PWU. I need to take a cover shot of Sid Vicious, and he shoved me down to the ground here.
I'm liking Sid more and more every day.
He just stared you down. I saw you, I kind of smell something over there.
Maybe there was a hot chick behind me. He was just looking her down. But Sid Vicious is prepared for the toughest match of his comeback since he broke his leg in 2000 when he faces this man, the PWU Heavyweight Champion, Too Cold Scorpio. Too Cold Scorpio, the man who last month, June 16, 2007, it will go down as a day that will live in Pro Wrestling Unplugged history forever when he dethroned Devin Moore in the Crazy 8 match, the PWU Match of the Year. Too Cold Scorpio is your reigning world champion, the first ever two-time PWU Heavyweight Champion. But right now, what he's going to be facing out of the ring is Sid Vicious, a man who holds victories over people like Hulk Hogan, Sting, Bret Hart, Shawn Michaels, top wrestlers, Big Van Vader, all kinds of people. Scorpio has got to be prepared for this matchup. As much as any world title match in PWU history, Scorpio versus Sid has that big match feel. You can feel the electricity in this building. Scorpio's having a little fun at ringside now, but he knows when he gets in the ring with Sid, it's going to be all business. Which one of these two men is going to come out on top? Their history in this business dates back all the way to the mid-80s. Both men started out, and they have worked their way all the way up to headlining in the most famous building in professional wrestling, the new Alhambra Arena, for the PWU World Championship. I am excited for this contest, Dan Cowie.
And it's going to be an exciting contest. Psycho Sid Vicious, Too Cold Scorpio for the PWU World Heavyweight title. Two very different individuals.
Yeah, you're saying two very different individuals, and you know what? That's very true.
Look at that sign, Flash Punk, Fear Scorpio.
A lot of people fear Too Cold Scorpio, and with good reason. Scorpio was taking on all comers. You know, when you were out with me for a while, I was listening to people that Sid has taken on and defeated. Scorpio has faced some of the most biggest international stars in wrestling history, from Kenta Kobashi to Eddie Guerrero to Mitsuhara Misawa. Everyone who is anybody in professional wrestling has faced Scorpio and Sid, and they've had their hands full with both of them.
Sid Vicious, though, taking on the likes of The Undertaker, Kevin Nash, Hulk Hogan.
Yes, I brought that one up earlier.
I mean, come on.
Ladies and gentlemen, this match is for the PWU Heavyweight Championship. Introducing the challenger, weighing in tonight at 305 pounds, from Marion, Arkansas, formerly of Germany, now making his home in Orlando, Florida, weighing in at a trim slim 230 pounds. He's down the slim trim, 222 pounds. He is the current PWU Heavyweight Champion, Too Cold Scorpio!
As much as this crowd loves to see Sid Vicious here tonight.
You know what though, you were saying Scorpio looks a little bit intimidated during the intros. I think it's finally hit him that this match with Sid is for real.
Yeah, I mean, this crowd's happy to see Sid here. Love seeing the fact that
here we go, Dan Cowie.
All right, I'm going to stop trying to make my comment here. I'm going to go ahead and announce this match. I got the Grammy or whatever it is, Emmy music playing or whatever it is. I'm going to talk too long.
Here we go, Dan Cowie. Perhaps the two biggest names to ever be in the same ring at the same time with the PWU Heavyweight Championship on the line.
And that is very true. No, I'll tell you what. Sid Vicious alone is a very big name. A big name matches a big body here.
And you know what, though? Scorpio has got to have a direct idea of what he wants to do. Sid's leg, as everybody knows, is weakened. If you haven't seen the video of when Sid snapped his leg, you are missing out on a throw-up moment, because it is one of the sickest things in wrestling history, and it's amazing that this man is even walking today.
It's amazing that he's walking. This is one of his first matches back wrestling again.
Yeah, and it's 7 years later. That's how bad that break was.
So, I mean, Sid Vicious is scary, is impressive, a great physique. But I'll tell you what, if Scorpio is smart, he will go right for that leg.
Yeah, Scorpio knows that he's going to be being overpowered by Sid, but I almost think he's letting Sid build up a false sense of confidence by letting Sid overpower him early on. Look at the smirk on Sid. He knows what Scorpio might be up to.
He's scowling like every individual here in this building, one by one.
You know what? Too Cold Scorpio knows what he has to do in this match. I think it's obvious. I was in a card ride with him earlier today. He knows what he has to do against Sid.
Wait a second. How the hell is it? Powers out. How the hell are we in a car ride with Scorpio?
Black Ink and Scorpio are the talk business. You know, Scorpio is just checking to see if it's the same Sid of old. He's been gone a while. He's been on the shelf.
He has been on the shelf for quite a while, has Sid Vicious been.
He's been gone long enough that they've actually come out with those classic action figures for him. That's how long Sid has been gone.
Look at Sid. I mean, Scorpio's a big guy himself. He's no small guy, but Sid is tossing around like he's a Barbie doll. Oh, Scorpio has shot it on Sid.
You know what, though? Even though Sid has the power and height advantage, Scorpio definitely is probably actually a lot quicker, and he has to stick and move in this match.
Sid Vicious. Look at him. He has not broken a stare. I don't think that guy blinked since he's walked through that curtain.
Yeah, Scorpio can definitely out-wrestle Sid. I think Sid knows that too. Maybe, like I was saying earlier, when Scorpio was luring Sid into a false sense of security by letting him overpower him, Sid is doing the same thing with Scorpio with wrestling maneuvers.
I mean, it's going to take a lot, though. I mean, Scorpio definitely is a fine, fine competitor, a fine wrestler. But it's going to take a lot to take down Sid Vicious with that big physique.
You know what? Sid right there. I don't think he has more finesse than Scorpio, but again, I think he used the power advantage there. Right there to take Scorpio over. Scorpio, he can't get any kind of grip on Sid. He has to stick and move. He's got to let his offense, his hard-hitting, quick offense, get to Sid and take him out, move by move. Chop him down like a big oak tree. Right.
Scorpio now, look at it go right forward on that arm. Now, Sid Vicious is known to use a chokeslam in his moveset. It's probably a good idea here to take out the arm of Sid Vicious.
It's a very good idea, and it also doesn't allow him to have a good chance to use his power bomb. He won't be able to get the right hook on Scorpio's waistline to lift him up. Oh, and now Scorpio's got it at a higher angle, putting extra pressure on the shoulder. It's almost got him in a... It's still a hammerlock, but it looks like Sid... Oh,
look at that shot!
And it's only going to take one shot from Sid to bring Scorpio down. And I think Scorpio, I was wrong when I said earlier, Scorpio's going to learn the hard way of how to wrestle a man Sid's size.
Oh, hard punch!
Oh, man.
You know what's odd about this is last month, Too Cold Scorpio was the biggest man in the match for the PW World Heavyweight Championship. He's now the smallest man in the match. And you know, Scorpio is a big individual.
This is the first time Scorpio has not had the size advantage since he's been here in Pro Wrestling Unplugged. And this is a good idea by Sid. You know what? The world title match is going to have more relaxed rules as we've seen in the past. So unlike the match earlier where Devin Moore and Z-Bo were being counted on, had to consistently break the count, Sid is going to be able to lay into Scorpio out here.
I don't think a referee here is going to want to count out Sid Vicious.
No. And he's not going to want to disappoint these fans by having a count-out ending.
He fears Sid Vicious.
I don't blame him.
I'll tell you what, I think these legends are out to get a referee here.
And you notice right there, Sid continues.
Oh, look,
he has pressed that ring apron. There's a piece of wood there, for you fans that don't know, into the spine of Scorpio.
He's a metal, like the metal of the ring.
Yeah. Scorpio's trying to fight back a little.
The pain on Scorpio's face.
I have never seen Scorpio this worn down this early in a match. I'm glad that was for us.
I think I heard a rib break.
Sid can do whatever he wants. He's cool with me.
Yeah, you're only saying that because he's got 2 inches from you.
Oh, Christ.
Oh, I think he just broke an eye ribbon, Scorpio.
That's where Scorpio keeps his food. He is taking Scorpio out.
Look at this.
Scorpio is just trying to push him away. You can't do anything else.
Oh, another kick. Scorpio is almost in the front row here.
Scorpio is.
Oh, look at him now. Scorpio is being pressed down onto the black guardrails here, the black steel guardrails here.
It's all about iron and steel tonight, and Scorpio is definitely having the steel used against him.
Look at the face of Scorpio, the pain and anguish. Since Scorpio's been here in Pro Wrestling Unplugged, I've never seen him being out-wrestled and manhandled by another competitor.
You know what, Scorps? I don't know what Sid has planned here, but it can't be good for Scorpio's abdominal area and back. That's what he's targeted right there.
Oh, look at him.
He's sitting on his lumbar area, and he's pulling up on his face.
The whole body is Scorpio.
Well, you know what? Sid's so big, no matter what he sits on, it's going to be the guy's whole body. The whole upper half of Scorpio is being worked on.
Listen to the screams of Sid, Psycho Sid, Vicious. Yelling at everybody in this arena, yelling at the referee. Was that a tap?
No. Scorpio's actually asking for the ref's assistance. He's too proud of a man right now to tap in a world title match.
And the referee here is trying to get away. Scorpio's pulling him in.
Sid Vicious. Scorpio's actually powering out of this.
Surprisingly.
He's got the heart of a champion, like we were talking about earlier. Hold all the titles you want. A champion's defined by his heart. And 2 Paul Scorpio has that.
The quick maneuvers, that's what's going to take out Scorpio. Or excuse me, Sid. Scorpio should have took to the fast-paced, high-flying action he's known for and not tried to power Sid Vicious.
You know what? I think Scorpio's actually in a false sense of like where he is in his career right now. Last month, he was the slowest man in the match. And that's not enough on him, considering who he's against, Devin Moore and Detox. But against Sid,
he's the fast guy in the match.
Exactly, and he's trying to wrestle the same style he used against Detox and Devin Moore.
Oh! Hard shot to the back.
Imagine being hit by Sid Vicious.
Oh.
I know you have no imagination, but imagine it.
I have an imagination. I don't want to imagine what's going to be like be hit by Sid Vicious.
You know what my imagination is telling me right now? 2 count only. My imagination right now is telling me that in about 3 minutes, the announcement, the winner and new PWU Heavyweight Champion, Sid Vicious, will be coming from Bob Ortiz's mouth.
Jake, you have an active imagination.
Tell me, does it look like that's not going to happen? Does it look like that's not going to happen? Does it not look like Sid Vicious is going to be the champion? Does 2 Cold Scorpio look like he's getting up anytime soon? Sid is the champion right now, whether anyone wants to admit or not. Sid Vicious should have the title on his waist. The rest of stop this. New champion, Sid Vicious. Scorpio ain't coming back.
Scorpio's doing this. Scorpio's been down and out plenty of times in his career and has fired back to win championships across this globe.
You know what? He's hit rock bottom in his career and he's come back on several occasions. But you know what? Sid Vicious is on a comeback trail without hitting rock bottom, so he's that much stronger.
Big elbow to Scorpio, but Scorpio did not go down. Scorpio's being ripped off the ropes. Scorpio ducks the clothesline. And oh my God! Power slam from 2 Gold! Scorpio, he's going upstairs! Moonsault! Taking out Sid Vicious too! Go!
And look at Sid! That was the wake-up call this sleeping giant needed. 2 Paul Scorpio is screwed. Sid Vicious is less than 2 minutes away from being a heavyweight champion. Mark my words, you mark.
That look didn't affect Sid. Big old boozle from Sid Vicious on a 2 Cold Scorpio.
And he's just strangling him right now. What?
Scorpio flipped down.
Oh.
Going again in a boozle.
Damn.
Slam.
We got a new champion.
He's calling for it.
Sid, the master and the ruler of the world, is about to be the champion, Dan Cowie. Stop Sid from being what the...
Is that, am I seeing a ghost?
I wish you were seeing a ghost. I wish we just weren't seeing him.
What is he doing? He's in the ring.
This guy's gonna pay for this if he messes with Sid.
Oh, a supposed legend killer. Wait a second, Scorpio rolls up.
His very own life against this maniac, this psycho, this vicious individual.
Helter appears to be taking his shirt off. Why, I don't know.
Oh!
What an idiot, so he can get a pink belly.
Oh my God. Scorpio to stop him. Wait a minute. Oh no, Scorpio's pissed. Oh, big kick to Helter Skelter. Scorpio's pissed that his match with Sid Vicious is ruined. Not a clear cut winner was really seen here. And Scorpio's now helping.
What? Big bad help.
Oh! Choke slam to the outside. Helter Skelter is down and is not good. Sid Vicious showing his respect for Too Cold Scorpio.
Okay, where's RC? RC, come on over here, my friend. Who's representing the clique? Ladies and gentlemen, these are two of your finalists to be the next Pro Wrestling Unplugged Commissioner. You voted them ahead, they're in the final 10. This is your next group you're going to be voting from. Let me give you a little lesson first about what it's like to be a commissioner, okay? Just a little tip for you, all you guys. Next month, this is the way to do it. Next month here in August, it's Fan Appreciation Night. What is Fan Appreciation Night? That's our way of saying thank you to everybody who paid their money to come to see our shows, who supports our product. And here's what we're going to do. Next month in August, the 18th, here, New Alhambra, every fan who comes in is an opportunity to put their name into a hat. Your names. We are then going to bring the entire locker room into the ring before the show starts. We will pick your names out of a hat, and you will decide who wrestles who right here next month.
That is unbelievable.
We said we're going to be fan-friendly. We said we're going to care to you fans and appreciate your money's been spent. We're going to let you decide who gets a world title shot. We're going to let you decide who gets a world tag team title shot. You can pick any match you want. Everybody in that has a chance at a name poll. You'll pick the wrestlers out of the ring. They will wrestle that night. Thank you. That's how you do it. Now, just to help me kind of get you guys like up to speed, see how you would do as a commissioner, I'd ask somebody to help me out to kind of indoctrinate you tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Prime Time, Amy Lee, and the Mad Doctor, Dr. Roberts.
Nate Stein, you know a lot about Amy Lee.
Unfortunately, I think maybe sometimes a little too much about Amy Lee John House.
But what a huge announcement that was, Stace Fine. You heard it right here in August. The fans are going to get to pick the matches right out of the hat. We're going to pick the names of the fans out of the hat, and those fans will get to pick the matchups.
What a great opportunity. Of course, I had an opportunity to talk with PW owner Tom Gordon before we came out here today, and he told me a little bit about this. And now, you know, we know how it is in wrestling sometimes. This is a 100% legitimate contest. Dr. Don, I'm sorry. Whatever it is, sorry. He scares me. He freaks me out just a little bit.
That's right. It's our third round here. The Commissioner Idol Finals will begin at the third anniversary event.
Whoa. I got my glasses getting a little fogged up over here.
That's good.
Okay, prime time. Strange man, doctor. We have over here Pirate. Pirate, let's give you a little test so the fans can vote who goes to the next round. Prime time. Give him a sample. Pirate.
This is the next contestant?
Next contestant.
What would you do if I said, I ain't working tonight, bitch?
What would you do?
Uh-oh.
Excuse me.
She said she's not working tonight? She said she's not working tonight? I don't know. I think I'd make her a match anyhow.
He's like the John Kerry right there, unable to decide anything.
That would be a loud fan. Question to you. Go ahead. Prime time. Give me a sample.
What if I said I wanted more money or I'm gonna kick your ass, Weasel?
What would you do, loud fan?
I'd have to ask the fans here if they believe that Amy deserves more money. Fans, what do you think?
Oh, wow. Good response there.
So the next contestant we have over here, Chris Calloway, did a great job. Give us a sample of what it's like having you work in the locker room for somebody as a commissioner. Hit him.
In the locker room.
Uh-oh.
Hey, bitch, now do something. Step up. You hear me? Do something.
What would you do?
I would strip you of that championship and send you back to the fucking fat barn you came from.
Uh-oh. The champ is here, guys.
Chris Calloway, ladies and gentlemen.
Gave it right back to her.
Biggest mistake. Very big.
Whoa. He ain't commissioner yet, and if he was, I'd bend you over the ropes and teach you prison life, punk.
Oh-ho!
As for you, just because you got itty bitty bitties, and I got big old titties, I guarantee you, you will never tell me what to do. Oh. So you take your itty bitty and step right now.
I hope she cries.
Okay, Joanne, you just had one of your wrestlers come up and tell you the commissioner. What would you say?
First off, Amy, you may have big titties, but at least mine are natural, bitch.
Round. Other videos besides those are up. Pick who you want. What do you got there, Dr. Don? We say, Dr. Don, it's good to be the king.
Yeah, Nate Stein was just, what is Dr. Don throwing people? That's not confetti.
I'm a little afraid, you know, I think I need, like, I need, you know, that little, like, moisturizing hand soap that, like, dissolves when you touch it. I need to be poured and covered in it right now. I feel a little disgusting.
You know what? Hazmat. If you want to feel better, why don't you just touch Teddy Fine?
Oh, Lord.
Everything gets so fine after touching T5.
You know, I kind of figured, Jake, that you'd be more on the side of the underhanded schemes of TJ Cannon and Bruce Maxwell, the best around.
You know what? Teddy Fine and True Blood, they are a PWU homegrown talent team. TBA is trying to make their name on the Bosom Buddy by attacking them over and over, and he's in a good mood right now, Teddy Fine and True Blood. But I guarantee you, once the bell rings, we're going to see a vicious side of True Blood and a vicious side of Teddy Fine, because they have to have revenge on their mind tonight.
And of course, you have seen over the last couple of months, the opportunities TJ Cannon and Bruce Maxwell have taken to try to take out Teddy Fine, just to humiliate him, to insult him in any way they can. But now it's going to be 2-on-2 as Teddy Fine keeps with his regular partner, the other half of the Bosom Buddies, the one and only Drew Blood. And I think he wants to live up to his name tonight as they face off against the best around.
Of course he does. You know, like I said, they're going to have fun now. This is their time. This is actually almost a release before they have to show that aggression in the ring. And I see Nate Stein scouting something from the Whiteboard Mafia over in the corner.
That's not the Whiteboard Mafia. They don't use foul language.
You can pay attention to your PWU fans.
These fans are asses.
But of course, you can check out PWU on MySpace at www.myspace.com/prowrestlingunplugged.
The fun with that sign over there?
Something around those lines.
You know what, guys? I honestly believe by the end of 2007, the Bosom Buddies will be the PWU.
And gentlemen, introducing first, from Philadelphia, 187 pounds.
Streamers.
At 228 pounds from the pages of the T-Fine magazine, this is Prime Time Teddy Fine!
Since when are we in Japan?
You know what?
Ladies and gentlemen, Bosom Buddies!
You know what? Before I got so rudely interrupted by Bob Martin, I was about to say it. By the end of 2007, the tag team titles will be around the waist of the Bosom Buddies.
I concur. For once, I concur.
Better.
You and Jake Black agree on
something? Yeah, I'm kind of surprised myself.
Now, you know, Jake, you've gained quite a reputation here at Pro Wrestling Unplugged and at ProWrestlingPress.com for your excellent managerial services. What advice do you think you would give the best around TJ Cannon and Bruce Maxwell as they go up against the Bosom Buddies?
Charge the ring and get right into a fight with Teddy Fine and Drew Blood, because they will not be expecting that. Finesse is what the best around usually use, and this is the song that fits them the best, because the Karate Kid, Ralph Macchio, is coming out an angel on their wings tonight when they take on the Bosom Buddies.
Look at these two. Look at them. They think they can be as fine as T-Fine. Look at them.
Look at their tights.
They're pink.
Traction. They're hot.
Okay. The best around.
You know, if these guys get all the girls, they like to shake the pink.
Please stop, Jake.
You know, I don't even know what to say sometimes.
Wait a minute. Teddy Fine's pissed.
Yeah. Hey, I said it.
But you know what? Two Bosom Buddies. The TBA has isolated Teddy Fine.
That's smart wrestling.
But you know, that's what I'm saying. That's why Teddy Fine is so pissed off right now. He's received the brunt of attacks from the best around.
Ladies and gentlemen, hailing from the best wrestling country in the world today, Canada.
Yeah.
What?
At a combined weight of 366 pounds.
You're going to call it international incident.
You know how they came up with the name for Canada?
How?
There's all these fur traders. They put all the letters in the alphabet in a bag. They pulled out C-A, then an N-A, then a D-A. Canada.
Well, a whole lot of announcers are sitting next to me that I don't like.
That is Nate Stein humor, ladies and gentlemen.
I know you're not talking about me, Jake.
I'm talking about both of you.
Oh, come on, Jake. Power surge. I thought we had something.
Pension's ever on the line, I guess we'll have something, but you're not Chuck and I'm not Larry, but these guys are the best around. Slap on them, Bruce! Slap on! Get a bow and arrow and shoot them, TJ! Take these people out!
A bow and arrow?
They probably didn't even pay money to be here!
A bow and arrow.
What?
Well, Jake Black is a little okay, just, a little?
Okay.
He's the one who started the Black Plague, don't you know?
He wishes he did. I had some involvement. Big chop from Drew Blood.
Yeah, the best round trying to pull some of the antics they've been pulling on Teddy Fine, getting Drew Blood a sneak attack, but Drew Blood had it scouted.
TJ Cannon was a little disoriented, and Drew Blood able to take the advantage. Now TJ Cannon coming off the ropes, but leapfrog from Drew Blood. Oh,
big kick.
Beautiful leg lariat. We'll take big kick, because I'm cool with Dan Fink out.
Everybody's cool with me, Jake.
Yeah, well, I'm cool with both of these tag teams. But you know what? I don't know. Who do you guys think are going to win this one? Let's be honest here. There's a crunch here.
I'll tell you what, though. The best around, they're a young team. They almost got lucky that they're here in PW. Kind of almost like a freak accident, almost. Not doubting their abilities whatsoever. But Teddy Fine and Drew Blood have proven themselves time and time again here in this building.
Well, let's look at the history of the best around in this building. April 28th, Pro Wrestling Press, they had a singles match against each other that earned them a spot here in PWU. Later that night, after basking in the glory of that debut and the success of it, Teddy Fine and Drew Blood defeated them in tag action. Fast forward to Pride, Pain, and Punishment. Teddy Fine teams up with the best around, loses the match for them against the Tomasellis, and that is where this feud really began.
I would have said he lost the match for them. I mean, it was a tag team. They had just enough opportunity to try to take advantage of that match and pull off the victory. Now, beautiful
air spin.
Wow, where did that come from?
Shades of Bob Backlund, guys.
Why did he go an airplane spin when it's more like a helicopter? Because the helicopter is actually another move.
Okay.
Oh! Beautiful.
That was beautiful. Drew Blood incorporating new offenses in his matches so that his opponents don't have a full opportunity to scout him.
TJ Cannon not so disoriented that Drew Blood could keep the three, keep him down for the three count. Now being whipped off the rope. TJ Cannon reverses.
Oh! Knee to the back.
Elbow to the face.
Oh! Insecurity taking out Drew Blood.
And we just saw Drew Blood's eyes roll right in the back of his head right here in front of us.
Now TJ Cannon, the immaculate TJ Cannon, on the attack of Drew Blood. Oh, what a fist of fury on the back of Drew Blood, the background attack by Bruce Maxwell just a few moments ago.
Maybe this is the first time that Bruce Maxwell and TJ Cannon had an opportunity to face off against Drew Blood.
Both members are in the ring.
Smart tag team wrestling.
Oh, everybody's been into a cutter.
You know, they didn't quite connect that move the way they wanted to, but they were able to distract, had the ref distract Teddy Fine for long enough time that no matter what they hit, they were going to have an advantage.
Now cover here. And look at Teddy Fine. You can see the aggravation on his face. He's waiting. He's biting. He can't wait to get in there to try to get his measure of revenge against TJ Cannon and Bruce Maxwell. And TJ Cannon tried to model off his new wrestling attire.
It's nice attire.
Oh! Big clothesline splash over in the corner against Drew Blood.
Drew Blood being sent out to the outside here, and TJ Cannon on the attack. Teddy Fine out distracting the referee. He doesn't know he's doing more damage to his partner than his own buddies. Oh! Onto the guardrail!
You know what? Teddy Fine almost has a blind rage burning in him, because if he did not have such pent-up anger against TBA, he would not allow himself to be tricked into these plans, these Acme-style tag team wrestling sneak attacks.
I'm surprised Teddy Fine.
Oh, wait a minute. Ooh. TJ Cannon mocking Teddy Fine with his own version of the camel clutch, riding him like a motorcycle.
Well, you know what? If he's on that motorcycle too long, he doesn't go for a pin. He'll jump the shark and lose this match.
TJ Cannon now in the ring here and on the attack of Drew Blood, the little buddy of Teddy Fine. The guy who's come out the last 2 months has actually helped Teddy Fine from these attacks from TBA.
TJ Cannon keeping the offense on Drew Blood right now, whipping him out from the opposite corner. TJ Cannon measuring him. Here he comes in.
Drew Blood sending him. Wait a second. Drew Blood is down, and it is not good.
Oh, but only a two count.
My cliche, yes, I know, Jake.
And right now, I'm pretty sure TJ Catton knew he wasn't going to win the match with that move right there. But he's just trying to get under the skin of Teddy Fine. He knows that every time Teddy Fine sees Drew in trouble, and
whoa, what a time.
TJ looks like he's gone for a great move here. He's being distracted by the crowd.
And he might have taken some precious.
Oh!
Crash and burn!
Phoenix style splash misses.
Tags in Bruce Maxwell. True Blood is the destiny of attack.
Oh, that was brilliant.
Bruce Maxwell quicker than a hiccup into that ring.
Thank you, Jim Ross.
Good old DC over here.
That's right.
True Blood trying to rally the crowd up for some support. He's up on his feet, but Bruce Maxwell, wait a minute, now Bruce Maxwell's up.
He's inched even closer to a corner. True Blood, he is a little powerhouse of a man.
Well, he's stocky.
He takes it, Teddy Fine.
Brilliant maneuver.
Wait, Teddy Fine,
brilliant maneuver.
Keenan to knock through the tag.
And now both members of the Best Around have an opportunity to try to lay in more punishment, more double team punishment to Drew Blood.
And these guys, tandem offense, are some of the best you've ever seen. They're almost like a modern day Rockers.
Rolls them up. Two, and a kick out after two.
They're trying to live up to their name, the Best Around. And right now they're taking it to Drew Blood. Drew Blood's been in there the entire time so far.
Oh, leg drop. Almost severing the head of Drew Blood. Two. That kick out.
And
two.
You know, Drew Blood's been having neck problems for almost a year now, dating back all the way to August last year.
Jinx.
I said the thing three times and you find your soda or something.
Why don't we concentrate on the match? You joke around too much. Oh, big boot by Drew Blood in the corner. Whoa, what a clothesline!
I'll do the color commentary now.
Potty mouth joke insert here. I'm Jake Black.
You know what? For once, I think you should take the fact that these two men are putting their body on the line, all for a shot to move up the ranks here in the tag team division here in PWU. And this grudge match that has been brewing for 3 months is about to hit its climax when these tags are...
Like that Bruce Maxwell went in without a tag. Keenan, come on now, do your job.
So close, almost a tag made to Teddy Fine, just inches away. You almost saw their fingertips touch.
Well, I'll tell you what, TJ Ken tagged Teddy Fine just a moment ago.
Hey, you know what? Maybe if we get a new commissioner, we'll put two refs in each match so stuff like that can't happen. Why don't you suggest that to your boys?
I should suggest that. It's a good idea. Soccer, three referees, actually four officials.
Well, soccer's stupid.
Football has like 15 officials.
Football's not even real.
Oh, wait a minute. Drew Blood up and over. Oh, caught DDT! Did you see that impact right on the top of the head of TJ Cannon?
I saw it, Nate.
Drew Blood has a choice. He can go for the pin, or he can tag in the fresh Teddy Fine.
Teddy Fine is more than fresh, I'll tell you that right now.
You realize what you just said? Anyway, Drew Blood is inching towards Teddy Fine, and Maxwell makes the tag.
Teddy Fine!
Uh-oh!
Finally in the...
Oh! Look at those forearms! Vicious chop! Add another one! And again, just laying him in!
The fire is inside of Teddy Fine right now. I have never seen him take out two individuals that hard and that furious. Wait a second. Could this be it? The Fine!
Oh.
Cover! One, two! Oh, and Bruce Maxwell breaks up the cover here.
That was surely going to be a three count if Bruce Maxwell hadn't broken it up, guys.
Teddy Fine is going to goop around jet skis, but he is all business here tonight at Iron and Steel.
And this crowd, this full house, and when I say full house here at the New Humber Arena, we had to turn people away at the door. Every seat is full. Everybody is standing on their feet for prime time, Teddy Fine.
And his trademark.
He saved the tab on that cam, and Teddy Fine is down.
Pride himself there, Jake?
Uh-huh. But Teddy Fine could not pride himself because he wasted too much time before setting up for the can opener.
Both TJ Cannon and Bruce Maxwell have Prime time, Teddy finds the corner, ripping off to the other corner. They say it through one, slowly climbing up top.
What was that?
Whoa! Roll up, man!
Oh, he's attempting a small package, goes hell off, now he goes for it again. One, two, three!
Ladies and gentlemen, 10 minutes, 17 seconds. Your winner, the team of Drew Blood, Teddy Fine, Bosom Buddy!
The Bosom Buddy's victorious. And they have to be in line for a tag team title shot in the very near future against either the SATs or All Money's Legal. Jordan wins the tag team title inside Steel Cage here later on tonight at Iron and Steel.
If anything, I think this just proves that by the end of 2007, these men will be tag team champions.
Wait a minute.
The best around just threw Drew Blood out of the ring.
Teddy Fine. Teddy Fine doesn't know what's going on behind him. Oh, turn around by TJ. There's a tag.
Right hand.
Uh-oh. Widen him up.
Oh! Oh!
Just sandwiching his jaw in between the feet of TJ Cannon and Bruce Maxwell.
The best decapitator around.
They could have broken his jaw right there.
Look, and now they're kicking the dirt on primetime Teddy Fine.
And Drew Blood is still out on the outside. Wait a minute, I see some signs of life from Drew Blood on the outside.
I mean, Teddy Fine pretty much gave respect to them. Told them after that first match against them at the ProWrestlingPress.com event that they like their style, they like the fact that they work here, and all that stuff. And this, the way they've been treating them, this is ridiculous.
I think the exact words Teddy Fine was like, he's like, they're like, I like your style. He's like, I like your moves. But since then, this relationship has crumbled.
And for Iron and Steel.
This place is absolutely packed from wall to wall. And we're seeing the entrance of the Southern Stomper. He is Luke Hawks.
And you know, here's a guy who has been making waves here in pro wrestling on vlog. And tonight, he plans on continuing his success here in his three-way dance.
An amazing opportunity for all three competitors here tonight in this three-way dance. It'll be great to see all three of them go at it here in the middle of the ring. And it's definitely going to jump them up a little bit here in the rankings.
All right, wrestling up front.
Uh-oh.
Now, as everybody knows, I'm the undefeated king of the three-way dance. But, and this is a big but, you are misinformed. Tonight, I don't have a three-way dance. Tonight, it's a singles match. It's one-on-one. Me versus some piece of trash from New York named Eddie Kingston. I tell you what, Kingston, get your ass to the ring, boy. I want to see you face to face.
Thanks, Dying Luke. Hawks is going to have his hands full with the King of Diamonds, Eddie Kingston.
I can't believe he just called him out like that. Does he know what he's getting himself into against Eddie Kingston?
And here he comes.
It's the King of Diamonds himself. And look at the look of determination in the eyes of Luke Hawks.
I don't know if Luke Hawks has been doing his homework and watching videotapes, but Eddie Kingston is a man that can get the job done.
Ortiz, it's obvious. Kill the music. It's obvious this man doesn't need a ring introduction because y'all know who he is, right? You know who Eddie Kingston is. He's a local jackass who wrestles in this area for pennies.
Uh-oh.
Me, I'm an international, worldwide superstar. Uh-oh. You see me on MTV. You see me in magazines. And hell, last week, you see me on SmackDown.
Even though he got his backside handed to him.
Since I'm a nice guy that
Duncan might walk. He might take that walk. He might be thinking about it. Luke Hawks might be a little too much for Eddie Kingston.
Now Eddie has the mic.
I'm sorry. He's a funny dude. Give it up, ladies and gentlemen.
Nate Stein Kingston is laughing at Luke Hawks.
He's a comedian, right? That's the whole deal here? No? You, Dane Cook? No? You know what? I can't. To be honest with you, be easy. I'm just trying to be nice, partner. Be easy.
The Saints suck!
They do suck. But you know what's funny? I did see you on SmackDown.
Get your ass off.
I did. He was on SmackDown for what?
Oh, 40
for
seconds.
All 30 seconds. That's how long you were on SmackDown, right? Good job.
What? What's going on? Wait a minute. What's John McChesney doing here? This was a three-way dance. It got changed to a singles match.
But now the Riddler, John McChesney, and Nate Stein, you saw the message that Batman Johnny Cashmere received from the Riddler, John McChesney. But the big question is, what is he doing here tonight in the ring with Luke Hawks and Eddie Kingston?
Take a way to find out. Referee Derek Sabato's a little confused. John McChesney asking for the microphone.
Listen, would both of you just please do me a favor and shut up? Listen, I did not come here tonight to be any Riddler. I came here to do what I do best and what the fans in Philly want to see.
He chopped him real hard now. They're exchanging now with Kingston. Kingston with that forearm. Oh, Kingston and McChesney seem to be like they formed a team here.
They're like sharks smelling blood, and the blood has the name of Luke Hawks.
Double back elbows there by McChesney and Kingston. On the Luke Hawks. Oh. Snack suplex.
Only gets a two out of it.
Into a bridge and only picked up a two.
Uh-oh. Northern Lights. Held on. Oh, but Eddie Kingston knocks McChesney off.
Well, now, I don't think the team's going to last too long.
McChesney saying he wants to win this match against Eddie Kingston. Eddie Kingston's like, oh, I understand. But he wants to win this one, too.
He wants to shake his hand.
Oh!
Oh, you can't trust McChesney. He's an opportunist.
Eddie Kingston being ripped off the ropes. Coming back off. Oh, beautiful drop kick from John McChesney.
Oh, now.
Oh, but Luke Hawks is back up. Forearm shot.
He caught him right up in the jaw with that forearm now. Oh!
Shots now being fired back and forth between McChesney and Luke Hawks. Chops being shaken up. Punches right to the skull. Irish whip reverse into the corner. McChesney coming off. Oh, super kick connects from Luke Hawks.
A perfect super kick there, and he delivered it right to the jaw of John McChesney.
Oh, but Eddie Kingston. Eddie Kingston breaking to the outside. Luke Hawks
took his mind off of Kingston there and got caught now. Kingston with those right hands. And a chop.
Oh,
Luke Hawks.
That one just echoed right through the building. Oh, forearm shots back and forth between McChesney and Eddie Kingston. I mean, excuse me, Luke Hawks and Eddie Kingston.
And that chop just knocked him every down the aisle. Luke Hawks with a low blow there at the advantage. Kingston fighting back.
Oh, headbutt from Eddie Kingston. That laid out the Southern Stomper.
A headbutt out of nowhere now. Hawks broke up that count. That's why neither man could get counted out there.
McChesney now getting to his feet.
Uh-oh.
Here he comes. The line is flying right through the air. And he caught Hawks and Kingston. And now all three men are down, but McChesney just got back up.
Able to maneuver himself. Able to be the first one back up to his feet. And he is enjoying his moment right here in this packed house in the new Alumni Arena.
Right across the steel guardrail.
His grandchildren, if he has any, are going to feel that one.
Luke sees the opportunity.
Come on, Fabulous!
Oh, block!
Fabulous.
Oh, butterfly suplex! Beautiful! Into a release there!
Eddie Kingston
now powered up. Just a big thump in the corner. Oh, headlock suplex.
Goes for cover. One, two.
Hooked that leg, but still only picked up a two.
And Luke Hawks, you know, he's taken most of the punishment so far in this matchup, but still able to kick out.
Oh, another forearm shot right to the face. And again.
Kingston winded up. Oh, wait a minute. And Luke blocks it.
Luke telegraphs it. Caught him in the shoulder with that kick.
Didn't get the full impact from it. But enough to knock the King of Diamonds, Eddie Kingston, down. Oh, Luke's dazed. I don't think he sees John McChesney. Oh, what a drop kick.
High elevation there on that drop kick. McChesney got out of that ring, and he took a breather, and he's back.
Now Kingston has McChesney. Oh, dumps him right in the back of his skull.
Not for long. He hit the back of his neck there. That could be it for McChesney.
Oh, but Luke Hawks stops it.
Oh, where's he going? Oh, driving him head first. He planted him there. Now he has to get over there and capitalize. Goes for a cover. Hooks that leg.
Oh, with John McChesney jumping in to break up the count.
Oh, McChesney now got Hawks in the corner with that big chop.
Him off the ropes. Luke Hawks reverses.
Oh, but off comes Luke. Oh, McChesney able to maneuver himself out of the way. Oh, with a big kick to the face.
Nice use of the ropes there. And just a driving forearm.
His face just bounced off that steel guardrail.
Oh, Luke Hawks comes in, but he's caught by Eddie Kingston. Melvin rolls him up. This guy has a hold of the tights. Look!
I didn't see that!
What do you mean you didn't see it? Right in front of us.
Ladies and gentlemen, 6 minutes, 14 seconds. Your winner of the match, Luke Hawks!
And Luke Hawks wins the match.
And Eddie Kingston can't believe it. Look at the look of surprise on his face. But wait a minute, here comes John McChesney again. Having a little stare down exchange of words with Luke Hawks. McChesney's definitely not happy about all of this.
Oh, but wait, look! What? What? What's going on? Oh, come on! Working over any distance. Luke Hawks and McChesney administering the boots and those right hands.
Just beating down at a kick. What? Oh, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Who is
yep.
Batman and Robin, the Boy Wonder, and Trent Acid. But you know who has to be under that mask. It's none other than the new Batman, Johnny Cashmere, and the Boy Wonder, Jimmy Clydesdale, and Trent Acid coming to the rescue of Eddie Kingston while being beaten down from John McChesney and Luke Hawks, the Southern Stomper.
That's right, there he is, the Blue Batman! With the Boy Wonder, saves the day! PW's own superhero!
You know, I know Eddie Kingston has to be grateful, but I think he looks a little confused right now.
Eddie Kingston don't know what's going on right now. Look at his face!
Don't worry, I actually have a ton of respect for you, and what I have to announce out here involves you too, so stick around 1 minute for me. Now, as all of you you people can tell by the expression on my face,
John?
I'm damn excited about something. Well, Batman has not one, but two big announcements I'd like to make right now. The first, I want you all to know, as our part of fan appreciation, that I have talked to my butler, Alfred, and I guarantee you that the Batmobile will be here at a Pro Wrestling Unplugged event in the very near future.
Oh, he's going to bring his car. Next time, he might be the one driving.
I thought you were Alfred, John House.
Yes, yes. Now, number two, and this is the big one. Some of you may already know that Batman and Robin and the Backseat Boys and Eddie Kingston and Devin Moore and Z-Bar and Team Pitt and Teddy and Drew and all of us are going to be on Philadelphia.
This is an awesome opportunity for Pro Wrestling Unplugged.
That's right. Almost 300,000 homes every single week. Right there on your television, you're going to get to see Power Surge TV.
That's unbelievable, Nate Stein.
So keep checking on ProWrestlingUnplugged.com as we make our announcement in the next couple of weeks as to our date and our time in the new fall season.
How friggin' awesome is this?
It's unbelievable, Nate Stein.
Now, one of the last things I want to say, Mr. Eddie Kingston, regardless of what I might look like, I'm a good man with a good soul, and you, sir, deserve to be on television.
Yes, he does.
Welcome. Now, before I leave, all you great people, Trent Acid, you think they want some free Batman cards?
I know you do, John House.
Oh, I already have a box.
I said, do you think they want some free Batman cards? Eddie, why don't you help us out? Dig in. Let's hear it, people.
Uh-oh. Sit down, Nate, sit down.
Hey, this is cool. It's like being a kid again.
They're not, you don't put that in your pocket.
Hey, shh. No one needs to know. Eddie Kingston getting in the action.
Uh-oh. That one almost hit you. You missed it.
This fall, ready? Same bat time.
There you go.
Same bat channel. Television, Nate Stein. Television.
Pro Wrestling Unplugged has the offer at ProWrestlingUnplugged.com. And right now, you're seeing one half of the New Jersey Independent All-Stars. This is the original Boondock Saint, Lucky.
And here he comes, Lucky, for Nate Stein, the big announcement about PWU's Power Surge TV. Nearly 300,000 people will get to view Power Surge TV from their own living rooms.
That's right, Pro Wrestling Unplugged making their way to television here in Philadelphia. This is a tremendous opportunity, and you know, it only gets bigger from there.
Ladies and gentlemen, from Hoboken, New Jersey, weighing in at 155 pounds, this is Lucky!
You know, I don't know about Jersey sometimes. I know you're from there, John House, but you know, Jersey's a unique place.
Well, you know, it's very easy. We pay the highest taxes. We pay the most for gas.
Which you don't pump.
Uh-oh. Yeah. We don't have to pump our own gas. That's one thing great about it next time, is the fact that we don't have to pump our own gas.
Getting ready for this matchup here, Lucky. Being checked out by referee
Derek Sabato.
Security over there checking out the guardrails. I'm sorry, the ring post.
Security checking out the ring post.
Making sure everything is good.
I guess Luke gearing up, or excuse me, Lucky gearing up.
Not sure where his opponent is. If I'm not mistaken, I think this is Detox's music.
Oh, wait a minute! It's Detox!
Oh! And Lucky hightailed it out of there. I don't like this punk Nate style. I don't like him.
You know, about half a year ago, I thought you were even having like best friends.
Well, you know what, Eric? That's the, I mean, Nate, that's the worst. The worst part about it. Detox is taking the wrong road. I keep trying to tell him, but he don't listen to me.
Well, I remember the road he took when he ducked you in the face a couple months ago.
And he did it when my back was turned.
And now these two squaring off, Detox and Lucky. This is going to be an action-packed, high-flying matchup from corner to corner. You never know where these two guys are going to come from. And we have him right here at Pro Wrestling Unplugged. Now the standing arm ring applied from Detox, just wrenching away on the arm and shoulder of Lucky.
Nate Stein, do you think Detox is fully recuperated from that huge crazy eight matchup?
You know, in a way, I don't know who could be, but if anybody could, it could be Detox. Detox is young. He has a lot left to give here in the world of professional wrestling.
Uh-oh.
Lucky maneuvering out of that arm ringer into one of his own. Now a hammerlock. And now right into a headlock. Great chain wrestling from Lucky. Wonder where he learned that from.
He's got that side headlock applied. Now wrenches down. Detox trying to fight back. Shoots him off.
Oh, but met with a shoulder tackle from Lucky. Lucky now coming off the ropes.
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh, but leapfrog from Detox. Beautiful. Oh, caught with an arm drag.
Right, he brought him with that arm drag. That needs to keep Detox down. You don't want Detox hitting those ropes, walking those ropes, and hitting him high back maneuvers.
You know, we're seeing this match just now get started with great wrestling from these two so far.
Uh-oh.
Oh, Detox caught him. Beat down Lucky a little bit, send him off the ropes. Oh, beautiful European arm drag. Detox lands on his feet. Oh, blocks the kick. There's Lucky from Detox. Lucky sends Detox off the ropes, ducks a clothesline.
Oh, but Lucky trips him.
Just stuck his foot right out there. It's a little low.
Well, that was a smart thing to do there. He caught him. He hit face first on that canvas.
Detox holding his mouth. A little surprised that Lucky pulled one over on him. Detox, a proud graduate of the XFC Wrestling Academy. Of course, you can check out more information about that at ProWrestlingUnplugged.com. So tremendous trainers. Oh, wait a minute. Detox, is he now reversing an Irish whip? Oh, knee right to the face of Lucky.
He caught with that knee now. Lucky on the outside. He's got to watch Detox. He's got to keep one eye on him at all times. He's a sneak.
Lucky's on the outside.
You cannot trust a sneak, Nate Stein.
And speaking of which, Detox, that coming in shot from the midsection, shot from the back. Lucky using the barricade to stand up, now being dragged over to the opposite side of the ring. Lucky, he's rolling out from the other side. Thinks he got one over on Detox, but Detox, wait a minute, Detox! Slides right through the ropes, kicks Lucky right in the face, skins the cat right back in, springboard!
Wow!
Did you see the height? He almost touched the rafters.
The elevation, both men came down. Detox getting up slowly.
Tremendous action. And we're just seeing the start of it, I think. Detox. Big right hand to Lucky.
Working him on the outside now. Dumps him in.
Lucky down in the middle of the ring. Oh, Detox goes to cover. 1, 2.
Got a two count there. He's going to get that left shoulder up.
Not enough to take out Lucky. Detox now sending Lucky off the ropes. Coming off, but ducks a clothesline from Detox. Oh, goes for a crossbody, but caught.
He caught him.
Oh, he's going to drive him right to that corner. Lucky able to maneuver out. Kick to the back. Oh, German.
Drove him right down the back of his neck. Now Lucky needs to stay on top of Detox.
I think Lucky's taking this opportunity to get back over the win that he just lost.
Uh-oh. Scoops him up. Drives him down to that canvas.
Right there in the middle of the ring. Lucky has Detox back up. Looks like he's sending him off the ropes. Oh, goes for a clothesline. Detox ducks. Oh, Lucky holds onto that center rope.
Yeah,
he's a smart thing. Oh, wait a minute, but not so smart, because here comes Detox. Sunset flip. Oh, but rolls out of it. What a kick. Oh, standing Phoenix splash. Detox kicked out of a standing Phoenix splash.
That's unbelievable. I can't believe he kicked out of that. Lucky now choking him across that. Did I say choking him?
Yes, you did. That's right, you said choking him. You know what he's trying to do against the ropes. And of course, you have to imagine what this would mean if Detox wins this match. He keeps himself in that tight of contention. We saw him in that tight of match last month at the Crazy 8. What is Lucky doing? Oh, elbow drop.
Drove that elbow down now.
But showing off a little bit before he did it. He's enjoying his moment of control.
Yeah, that could end up being a big mistake on Lucky's part.
Oh, suplex. Oh, draping him over the top rope. Oh, Detox trying to fight off Lucky. Oh, Lucky just scoop kicked him right in the face.
Detox hanging on there.
Uh-oh, now these are both on the outside ring apron. Oh, Lucky goes for a shot. Detox blocks. Oh, wait a minute. Detox. Detox hooking Lucky.
Uh-oh.
Oh, Lucky able to get to his feet. I can't believe it. Hits Detox right in the midsection. Now Lucky goes for a suplex. But I thought, oh!
Right on that ring apron. That ring apron just doesn't give, Nate Stein. And Detox just bounced onto the floor here of the new Ahava Arena.
I'm going to come to any wrestling event, we'll show you. That is a steel bar on the side of the ring, and Detox's back just crashed right into it.
Yes, it did now. Lucky tosses him back in.
Lucky signaling, he's gone up top. He's going to go for Detox. I'm not sure if he knows where he's at right now. Looks a little dazed.
Uh-oh.
Up comes Lucky. Oh, I think he's going to go for a flying hurricanrana. Caught 1, 2. Only a two count. Lucky has been going for a flying hurricanrana, caught by Detox and slammed right down with that powerbomb.
Caught out of nowhere, but Detox unable to follow up after that. After that powerbomb, both men are down.
I was talking about what would happen if Detox wins. What if Lucky is able to pull off a victory against Detox? Imagine the shot up the rankings you get here at Pro Wrestling Unplugged.
Oh, it would definitely be a big boost to Lucky here. Detox now. Lucky both on their feet.
Oh, Lucky goes in. Detox blocks it. Counters. Oh, butterfly. Oh, butterfly powerbomb, but misses the full effect.
It looked like Detox's right knee gave out on that. I think he may have blew out his right knee, Nate Stein.
Detox not able to connect with the full rotation on that butterfly powerbomb. But enough to knock the wind out of Lucky. Now Detox climbing to the top rope. Definitely high risk.
He's having trouble.
Oh, but Lucky bounces back to the ropes.
Detox may have blew out that knee, Nate Stein. Judging by the way he climbed those ropes, it could be possible.
It's the way the walls are. 1, 2, 3. Lucky just pulled off a victory against Detox.
8 minutes, 5 seconds. Your winner of the match, Lucky.
Lucky just beat Detox. This is an awesome opportunity. right here, Pro Wrestling Unplugged.
The knee.
He must have blew out the right knee. Something.
You know, you saw him when he tried to go for that butterfly powerbomb. It looked like his knee kind of torqued to the one side.
Look, he's holding his right leg. He was holding his right leg. Obviously, it gave out on Detox, but he was trying to climb those ropes. And Lucky seized the opportunity, and he caught him. And that very well may have been the difference in this matchup. Take a look, Snake Stein, Adam Flack.
That's right, it's time for the first of our two big steel cage main event matches. Both these two are grudge matches, and this is a grudge between two former friends and Adam Flash and Messiah.
Right, the last time these two men hooked it up here at PWU, Adam Flash, the man with the biggest ego in Philadelphia, got counted out of the ring.
You know,
on purpose.
Right, he's tried everything he can to try to keep one out of Messiah. And this time, there's no escape. What is Adam Flash looking for?
There will be no countout.
Oh, wait a minute.
The steel cage. It is nowhere to run.
Ladies and gentlemen, weighing tonight at 210 pounds from Southwest Texas, this is Adam Flash.
Well, Nate Stein, it is nowhere.
Here at Pro Wrestling Unplugged. Adam Flash already in the ring inside that steel cage, and he has a steel chair in with him. And now here he is, the one and only, the Messiah.
Well, here it is, it all sort of back about 4 months ago. Running his mouth, he was upset at Messiah, who was at that time his tag partner. No show, a tag match right here in this building. Since that time, Adam Flash has provoked Messiah, has called him out. But it's time to ready to lock it up. It's either a big pull apart for Adam Flash.
Ladies and gentlemen, weighing in at 219 pounds. Detroit, Michigan, Messiah!
And this time there's no escape.
And Adam Flash has talked the talk. He's been talking for months, but tonight he's gonna have to walk it inside that steel cage with his former best friend, Messiah. Works. It's simple. You either gotta walk to win this matchup. You either have to walk through that door and both feet hit the ground or climb that cage with both feet hitting the ground. Oh, we got a collar and elbow tie up. Messiah wasting no time with those right hands.
And now just Adam Flash able to block that blow right to the head. Oh, tries the counter.
Oh no!
This cage, a very dangerous, dangerous place. Oh, hold on tight! Oh, head first, right to the cage, and again!
And again! I don't flash to hit the steel.
Oh,
that suplex there by Messiah.
and now Messiah just pounding away on the head, the skull of Adam Flash. This is an opportunity for revenge for months of torment from Adam Flash.
Absolutely, now Messiah with that big headbutt in the corner. Messiah already hitting face first into that cage.
Oh, shoots them all. Messiah enjoying this moment of control over Adam Flash.
Yes, he is. And Flash is in trouble now. Oh, raking his head.
Oh, right against those sharp edges of that steel cage. Oh, he's stuck in between the ropes and the cage. Oh, knee right to the back and neck. Oh, and again, double knee.
Messiah already using that cage to his advantage now. Already in this matchup, Adam Flash is down, and he has tasted the steel.
Adam Flash had nowhere to go. No gift. Not enough gift from the steel cage. Punishment being dished out. Messiah has Adam Flash right in the middle of the ring. Has him up. Powerbomb attempt. Up high. Oh, wait a minute. No! Running him. Back first.
Right into that steel pole. That post.
And you know what? You might be seeing that cage shake, but there's no give on those steel posts.
Oh, it's solid steel, Nate Stein. Adam Flash is in a lot of trouble here. Uh-oh.
And Flash is up again. Oh, being run all to the opposite side.
And his head just bounced. The back of his head just bounced off that cage.
Adam Flash is being just beaten all around this ring right now from Messiah. Again, vicious headshot.
And so far, Messiah's had the total advantage in this steel cage matchup.
I think Messiah, does he see an escape? Does he see his way out over the top rope, or over the top of the steel cage? Or is he pushed up high? Oh, but Adam Flash has caught him, has the hold of his feet. Messiah was trying to fight him off. Oh! Low blow from Adam Flash.
Messiah should have got out when he had the chance. But the 16-year veteran caught him. Uh-oh.
Oh, no. Where's he taking him? Did you see that? Right there in the middle of the ring.
Superplex there by Adam Flash.
Right from the top of that cage.
And I think it's taking its toll on both men. Flash went for a cover there, but there's no pinfalls in this steel cage match.
The referee reminding him the only way out is over the top through the door. Messiah just pounding at the skull of Adam Flash, keeping on the punishment.
Uh-oh. Flash now with the advantage. He's got to stay on top of him. He can't get caught up with arguing with the fans.
He can't distract him from its target, which needs to be Messiah. Oh! And an opportunity for Adam Flash to give Messiah a taste of his own medicine.
Oh, he might be wasting too much time here.
Can you swallow?
Now you have to remember, here in this arena, it's been 95 degrees outside. The air conditioner's on, but with over 1,000 people in this building, and all the wrestling action that's been so intense, so heated all night long. It's like a furnace right there in the middle of the ring under all the lights.
Messiah's head just bounced off that top turnbuckle. And again.
Oh, it's like Messiah reversed. Reversed Adam Flash into that corner, that steel cage, that steel chair.
Right, head first, hit the steel. And both men are down.
Messiah's down. Adam Flash is down. Remember, the way to win this match is over the top of the steel cage or through the door. And you're not going to be able to do either another one if you're unconscious.
And Nate Stein, Adam Flash is busted wide open.
Uh-oh. Amasaya, he literally sees blood.
He's like a shark.
And now he showed it off to the fans here at ringside. On again! Head first into that steel cage.
Uh-oh.
And Messiah just pounding on the skull, right on that open wound on the head of Adam Flash.
Uh-oh.
Messiah now ripping away at that cut. Adam Flash now.
That blood is just dripping down his head and down his face.
And you hear the crowd in Philadelphia firmly behind Messiah. Now has Adam Flash picking him off. Adam Flash reverses Messiah. Comes off. Oh.
Big high back body drop there.
Messiah now a little winded. Adam Flash has been busted open. Both men a little worse for wear.
Uh-oh.
Oh no, Adam Flash. He sees that steel chair. He sees Messiah. Oh, he's just measuring him. Those quick elbows right to the face. Here comes Adam Flash. Oh! Boot scrape right across the face.
Oh, now Flash setting up that chair. It doesn't look good for Messiah.
I think he's unconscious.
Smashing that steel chair into the face of Messiah.
I'm surprised he's even up on his feet, even though he's been held up by Adam Flash.
Slams him down now. Oh.
Adam Flash is going up top.
Oh, wait
here's
a minute.
Here's his chance to escape.
I thought he was going to try to.
He's going off from that platform. Oh, leg drop!
Off the top of the cage!
But look at Adam Flash, he's in pain. He took some of that fall himself.
Adam Flash needs to try to follow up here. Maybe try to crawl over to that door. Or climb that cage.
Gotta get out the door, out the door, opens up.
Out the door. Or over the steel cage. Uh-oh. Flash now signaling. He's starting his climb. This could be it. Adam Flash beaten and battered.
And Messiah's dazed sitting on the ring. Messiah's up. Or Adam Flash is up. Messiah's now up.
Oh no.
Adam Flash. Oh, wait a minute. Oh! We talked about no give on that cage. Oh, like, oh.
Nuck to the eye there by Messiah. He just knocked him in the eye.
Oh, now it's a race. Both men are perched on top. It's going to be who makes it to the bottom first.
Oh.
But now Adam Flash is just pounding on the skull of Messiah. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. There's a table on the outside of the ring. Oh, and Adam Flash smashing. Messiah's skull against Messiah! Oh, wait a minute!
Wait a minute!
Messiah was the first one to the floor!
Ladies and gentlemen, in 10 minutes, 14 seconds, your winner of the match, Messiah!
Messiah wins this battle here tonight!
And Adam Flash did it himself!
He caused it to happen. He pushed Messiah through that cage, through that table at the ringside area, sending Messiah crashing down, losing his opportunity to pull away a victory.
Absolutely, Adam Flash caused himself this steel cage match.
Messiah Do you feel it? Do you feel it? Look at my goddamn face. I'm bleeding a little bit, but I broke your fucking back. Oops, did I say fucking? Is that not PR for TV? Well, you know what? Fuck you, fuck PWU. You son of a bitch. You have me won the battle, but you didn't win the war. I heard that time and time again. Usually on battles on the other half of me. But I tell you what, you son of a bitch. Whenever you come back, I'm gonna be a thorn in your goddamn side. Todd Gordon, Commissioner Idol, whoever runs this goddamn company, book this match again, because it's not my blood that's gonna be spilled. It's gonna be your goddamn blood, Messiah, Holy One. Your ass is mine, bitch.
So much action here tonight at Pro Wrestling Unplugged. So many matches here tonight you can consider main event matches. We have two Colton Scorpio versus Sid Vicious. We have Joey Matthews versus the international superstar Trent Acid. We just saw Messiah versus Adam Flash, a grudge match inside a steel cage that's been built for months. But if you want to talk about a battle, if you want to talk about a war, here's something that's been brewing here at Pro Wrestling Unplugged for over a year. Between the SAT and All Money Is Legal, all about the Pro Wrestling Unplugged World Tag Team titles.
That's right, nearly 18 months in the making here for this matchup. And finally, the SAT will get an opportunity at those belts with no shenanigans. They're going to take it home. Hey, ready Al, tonight.
You ready to see a show?
This is it, man.
Al, you see a show, see?
It's time for the belts to come back where they belong. That's what I'm talking about next time. Bring the belts home.
We'll see if that one pans out tonight.
Introducing the challengers. The combined weight of 422 pounds. From Puerto Rico, the Latin sensations, Joel and Jose Maximo.
Respect that they deserve. We've seen what they tried to do to get back those titles. They broke Derek Savato's wrist. They broke Missy Sampson's ankle. All in the name of trying to reclaim their PWU tag team titles.
That's right, Nate Stein. This is what it's all about. Tonight, it's all about the PWU tag team titles.
And this crowd here in Philadelphia is erupting for the men they're about to see, the current PWU Tag Team Champions, none other than Kay Murda and Kay Pusha. They are All Money Is Legal.
And here they come. Nowhere to hide for the champions tonight. No ketchup bottles, no disqualifications. It's a steel cage matchup for the PWU Tag Team. Don't you worry about me.
Hey, take him out. Take him out, Murda.
He may not be worried about me next time because they're stepping in there with the top tag teams in the world today. When I'm talking, Joel and Jose Maximo, the SAT, that's who they need to be worried about.
But All Money Is Legal, look at them. I mean, normally they come out here, they are humongous, tremendous fan favorites here at Pro Wrestling Unplugged. They're normally clowning around a little bit with the crowd. They're normally having a little bit of fun on their way out to the ring. But not tonight, look at them. I have never seen them look so intense, so focused against their opponents, the SAT.
From the Bronx, New York.
The SAT wasting no time now. And we knew it, the experience coming into play. Oh, no!
Oh, off that platform, already coming into play. And you heard the ring announcer say it earlier. This match, different than the last one. The end of this match isn't going over the top. It's by pin or submission, right in the middle of the ring.
Oh, throw that knee in the jaw.
And that forearm.
Oh! Bulldog from right across that knee.
Oh, and now neckbreaker, running, rolling neckbreaker off the knee. Oh, Maxima back up. Now both members of All Money is Legal just pounding away.
Although All Money is are the champions, they need to be the aggressors, and they know it. And they're going to work on Joel Maxima.
Oh! And back first, right against that steel cage. And now just pounding away is Murda.
That's what they gotta do. They gotta stay on top of the SAT.
Oh! Jose ordered Murder's face right into the side of the cage. Joel with Pusha. Oh! What a shot from Joel.
They kicked him right in the face there now.
Jose.
Jose working over Murda now.
Looks like I think he's set up for a slingshot.
Oh no, slingshot right into the cage! Right into that cage now, already using the cage as a weapon. The SAT wasted no time. They were ambushed. They were ambushed at the beginning, Nate Stein. But look, oh!
Pusha just fighting both members of the SAT off. Now coming up the ropes, over. Wait a minute, The SAT! Double team maneuvers.
No one double teams their opponents better than the SAT.
Oh, but wait a minute. Oh, but Murda. Murda came off and got caught by the SAT. Oh, no, wait a minute. No, we've seen this before. Oh, tried to send him right into that steel cage.
And you know, Mason, could the inexperience of All Money is Legal being in their very first steel cage match come back to haunt them right here tonight?
Cover one, two, only a two count from Jose Maximo. Now on top of Pusha. Only got a two count there. Murda's face being smashed up against the side of the ring. Joel, Jose with a knee drop on Pusha. So much action in the ring.
That's right. And they're keeping the champs grounded. Punishing them. Wearing them down. It's all about the PW Tag Team titles.
Snapmare from Jose. Coming off the ropes. Oh, running drop kick right to the face.
Yeah, he caught him there, goes for cover.
Only a two count.
Picked up a two count there.
So far the challengers, the SAT, are firmly in control. Oh! Running drop kick.
That's right, in the back of his head bounced off that steel cage. And Pusha is in a lot of trouble.
The SAT want to push out, deal out all the punishment they can against All Money is Legal. Oh, wait a minute. That's one suplex. Oh, that's two suplexes. We know who this is in the memory of. That Jose.
Oh,
that's about all three.
Oh, he caught him. He's got Jose up there. He's got him locked. Oh, but here comes Joel.
Joel trying to fight him. Oh, but now Murder's up.
Oh. Unbelievable.
Double German off a sunset flip in the corner. Taking all four men down.
All four men are down now. Looks like Murder's trying to. Murda's getting to his knees. Both teams taking punishment.
You know, this has been a long time coming between these two teams, like we've said before. And tonight, it's all coming down to this steel cage match between All Money is Legal and the SAT. Oh, now just grinding his head up against the side of the ring, or side of the cage.
There you go, he just dropped kick Pusha. Right in the face now. Going back to work on Murda.
Joel staying in control of both members of All Money is Legal. Just kicking away at the back of the knee. Just yanking away at the hamstring. And look, Joel has his leg wrapped around that bottom rope, added that leverage on.
That's right. He uses his experience there. Using that big time, big game experience now against All Money Is Legal.
Oh, look, look, using the ropes. Wait a minute, up to the center, recover, 1-2. Only get a 2 count. Just push a murder though. His leg is being destroyed. It's caught between the ropes and the steel cage.
But the SAT had a plan, look at that. Working on that leg. Joel now.
Oh,
Pusher spiked him with that DDT.
Jose and Joel staying in control of this matchup. Not really enjoying the crowd in Philadelphia. Of course, we know who they're behind. They're firmly behind. All Money Is Legal, the current. And maybe later tonight we'll see the reigning, continuing reigning. All Money Is Legal. Oh, wait a minute. Murda catches Joel. Or Jose, rather. Joel coming off. Oh, head scissors of his own. Oh, the pusher catches him. Enziguri. Now Joel, oh, big kick to the back of the head. Oh, Pusha now.
Pusha needs to follow up.
Pusha dragging his way up, going for a couple. 1-2. Oh, only a 2 count.
Only a 2 now. Pusha's got to put him away.
Pusha pointing up. Where's he? Oh, wait a minute. I think I know what he's doing.
And you know, next time, I think it's a disgrace that the fans of Philadelphia are behind All Money Is Legal.
Upset that you lost some. I bet you lost some money against the SAT from their losses before. Against All Money Is Legal. You're just jealous of their success.
Oh, pushing now up on that platform. Knocking down. Oh, knocking down. Jose, he's got him up.
Is he taking? Oh, driving him right against the corner. Joel is up. Oh, God. Oh, my God. Just spiked him. Spiked him with that face plant. Coming right up from the top.
That face buster from the top. Pushing out, trying to follow up. Push that leg, picks up a 1, picks up a 2.
Close. Only a 2. Pushing can't believe it. Arguing with referee Mike Keener.
We're about a hair away there. This match being over. Oh, now he's threatening the referee. He's a disgrace as a champion.
Oh, wait a minute. He's now looking at Jose. And now Murder's going up top. He's going to that other platform.
Uh-oh. Murder now.
Pusha has Jose. Murder, but Joel is up. Where's Joel? Joel now following Murder. Oh, but Jose with the low blow to Pusha. Pusha has Pusha. Oh! Kryptonite crutch just driving him.
Oh, no. This is not a good place for Murder.
Oh, my God. Jose and Joel on the top of the steel cage.
Oh, no, this is what I think. Oh, no.
You are kidding me.
Oh, no. They're going to kill him.
Oh, my God.
Damn. Damn. That's got to
be it. Just see 1, 2, 3.
That's it. That's it.
Spanish fly from the top. Steel cage.
Ladies and gentlemen, 10 minutes, 14 seconds, your winners and new PWU Tag Team Champions, Jose and Joel Maximo.
That's what I'm talking about.
Tremendous match, a great victory, and tonight it was all about the SAT, and they got that gold from All Money Is Legal.
Fair and square, Nate Stein, the brand new PWU Tag Team Champions, the SAT.
I still can't believe what I saw. The top of the platform. You want to talk about high risk. There is nothing more high risk than hitting the Spanish fly from the top of that platform on the corner of the top of that steel cage with such dangerous height. Almost going to the lights here at the New Alhambra Arena. What great action we saw. What a great match. Even if you didn't like how the SAT got to this match, they gave it their all. And they're walking out with that team going.
You can't even find anything wrong with it. You're mad because you can't find a way on how they cheated. They won fair and square and are the new PWU Tag Team Champions.
Push a hold on to those tag belts.
He's got to give them up. You lost. Be a man.
SAT. We've been through a war together. And I mean, you know what? I respect you guys a lot. You know? All you people don't know, but we came a long way with the SAT. All I want to say is thank you for everything, for the advice, you know. I know we stopped seeing eye to eye as soon as we got the PWU because we were searching these tag titles. But you know what? You guys earned them tonight. And all you fans should cheer for them. I respect you guys. And I love you.
This is sickening. It's disgusting. You lost.
And Murda's still out. His eyes just are not there. Push a whole Murda up.
Oh! That's what I'm talking about! That's what I'm talking about!
The Hitman running, oh come on! Yeah, do you like it? Your new tag champions, great.
Yeah, proud of them.
Great.
Proud of them.